Okie pokey.
So now we need to go here. I've got it muted. That can stay there. That is the link for it. This is the page. I'm not. Don't think we're gonna get.
Why are we wearing yellow?
No, because.
Hold on.
There's no reason to wear yellow.
We're not going to get anywhere near the number of people that normally watching because they'll all be watching the game. I think this would be something that people are going to look at after the game. So I think maybe we might only get 40 or 50 people watching.
Yeah, I need to mute the channel.
Oh, Becky.
So the good thing is I can actually do play-by-play because I've actually called play-by-play for soccer many, many times.
Ah. Well, in your head?
No. Actually, like live, like it like youth, like U18 state cup games, like championship games.
Remember, we're live now.
Yeah, I've wrote hello.
You've done.
Hello, everybody.
Right. We have so far one thumbs up. That's probably from Kris.
Nope, wasn't
Fucking
me.
Fucking hell.
Mm-hmm.
Save that shit there.
I need to move my camera because I don't want to sit here. Where can I go?
Just don't get all embarrassing illnesses on us.
No, I wanna sit there, but I can't because the camera's there and hang on.
The game's about to kick off and I'll start counting. Has yours kicked off? No, it hasn't, Chase. Of course it hasn't. Unless you're ahead of us.
No, it hasn't. They are city are in the center circle. Everybody's set up just waiting on whoever the twat of the referee is.
Yeah. All right,
so I'll pause my telly. So then we...
Okay.
Oh, they just kicked off.
Can you still see me from there, Danny?
I'm behind. Yeah, I'm behind.
Three. Okay, six. I'll wait till the clock. Actually, I'll stop my clock eight, on my telly off, at 10 seconds. 6, 7, okay. 8, 9.
I'm well ahead of you.
Paused at 10. Tell me when you're at 10, and then I'll press play.
10.
There you go.
Play.
There, 12, 13, 14, I'm 15.
Can you actually see me?
Yes, where? We can also see the telly, Kris.
Oh, well,
we're not allowed to broadcast the telly, are we?
I'm not broadcasting the telly.
No, you don't want to broadcast
the telly. I don't think we can't see the telly because of the angle of your camera.
Good. That's all right, then. Because I'm more comfy here than I am.
Yeah. It's a nice trophy in the corner. Is that anything in particular?
Which one? That one? That one.
I'd say which one. They've got fucking hundreds of trophies.
That one. Yeah. Are you referring to that one over there that I'm pointing at now?
Yeah.
That is the goals... Six-a-side Tuesday night league winners trophy.
Oh, I've got three of those.
Have you?
Danny, just a heads up, I'm at the 1 minute mark.
Yeah. Are you at 1 minute, Kris?
No.
Three.
I think
four,
I'm slightly ahead
five,
of you.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10. See if we've got any people listening. Oh, hello. We've got a.
I think I'm a bit ahead of you. I don't mind.
Now you pause your telly, then, don't you? You tit.
Yeah, but I... Because
otherwise you're going to be 2 seconds ahead of the Man City score first.
Hang on a minute. Where's the... God, I don't even know where the remote is. Where's the remote? There it is.
Have you got a box of chocolates on your table?
No, it's biscuits.
Fucking slag. Sorry. I got all calorific then.
Right, 130. 130 is what I've got.
I'm at 140 now.
Right, when you get to 150, really? When you get to 150, can you let me know?
45, 46, 47... 48, 49, 50.
Thank you. Right, I'm with you.
You must be... You were at the same time as me, Jace, and now you're not.
I was 9 seconds ahead of you.
I'm about a second ahead of you guys, but I won't give it away.
So what? Read out your time, Jace.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
2:10. 2:11. 2:12.
No, you're the same 2:13. As us. 2:13. We're all synchronized people. Okay. So what you want to do, if you're watching the telly and you're listening to us babble on about shit, then every now and then just put in the chat box and then we'll do a time check thing. Because at the moment, we've had to pause our telly for about 10 seconds so we're at the same speed as Jason.
I've had a tweet from TGCB_official. It works. So that's good.
Oh, very good.
I've also had a tweet from my Pirates captain. Hi.
In the window, we have got Dilly Wille. Dilly Wille.
Dilly Wille.
Hello. KZ Corner. And the wonderful Kelly's there.
I was just going to say, is Kelly there? If she's not, I shall...
Are we hearing her dulcet tones on transfer deadline day?
No, because she's working.
What? I'm just going to ban her from this window.
Yeah, I would. Put her down.
Bloody crazy cat lady. Matthew AFC. Hello, Kris, Danny, Jason. Hello.
Hello.
Sven Svensson. There you go. That's the kind of name I can deal with. Game on, boys. Come on, you Gooner 7. I think he meant to put the 7 in there. And Matthew AFC, Coswell scored today like the season. We drew 1-1 away at sea. Oh, go on then, you two. Prediction, I say Man City 3-0, Aguero first goal scorer.
I'll keep with the one I did on the pod, 2-2, and I had Mertesacker first scorer.
You're going for a Desmond.
Mm-hmm.
Go on then, Jace.
He don't care.
You going to give a prediction, Jace, or should we just fucking not bother?
I think he's on mute. Jace, you're on mute.
Yeah.
He said 1 minute.
Okay. Yeah. I actually scored last night. I have been playing FIFA 12, 13, 14, 15. I scored my first ever corner last night. I've put right button. I mean, what's the high lob ball in? Spun the ball a little bit. Mertesacker header from facing away from goal.
But was it anywhere near as good as my brilliant lob on
your fluky cross?
It wasn't a cross. I hit it from the touchline.
You crossed it from the halfway line.
No, I didn't. It was a wonderful goal. Unbelievable. Even Jeff said it was.
You know, we still haven't figured out why. When we look on our... I'm looking at the YouTube, and I'm looking at the our Google Hangouts picture. The one is back to front to the other.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? Yeah, like the main window is different to the YouTube window.
Yeah, but I'm actually transposed. Okay, let's see what else. Kelly, you guys are behind fast forward. No, we can't fast forward, Kelly, because then Jason is behind us. So what you need to do, we are at 4 minutes, 47, 48, 49, 50,
50, 51, 51 52, 52, 53. Kelly, you need to pause and wait for us.
And then we'll all be on the same time. Yeah. But then don't look at any... Hello, Dora. Are you crazy, puss? Are you crazy?
Oh, I still want to know why we're wearing yellow. This is just stupid. Why?
Probably because West Ham wore a shitty colour the other day try and flog more kits.
Yeah, it probably is a commercial thing, isn't it? Yeah. I understand when we go to Swansea because we've got white shorts and white, predominantly white socks. But Man City are in sky blue. There's no reason for us to be in yellow.
I know, it's shit.
Yeah, there is because it looks good, Kris. Stop criticizing. You're so negative all the time, Kris. You're so negative.
We're wearing yellow. Wenger out.
Gonna do another little tweety poo.
So sorry for the phone call, boys. The wife had we had some urgent family business we had to discuss. So my apologies.
Pringles or what flavour?
Outrageous. Are you tweeting again? Did you say? Watch us watching football.
Just watching. Yeah.
It's gone all Orwell.
If you're that sad.
That's the name of this. Watch us watching.
Yeah. Do you remember that popular 90s soap, Danny?
Watching, yes. Yeah. People watching. Sat in a pub.
Yep.
Dirty Northerners.
Isn't this Mourinho's definition of voyeurism?
Might well be.
Don't ever associate me with that pillar. There we go. Tweet received. Touch of Alexis has sent me a tweet. What did he say?
Hang on. Very nice.
I can't read. Oh, here we go. Perfect. Well, I won't go that far, but thanks.
Ah, Swedish Freddy has found the Easter egg at the end of the last podcast. What was it? It was Jason complaining about what time he had to be up, I think. I mean,
Jason complaining. That's a change.
You bastards, you!
I tell you what, right?
I was in bed having a cheeky tug.
Oh, God.
He's got a tugboat Willy thing. The cartoon character.
Nothing to do with you. Did you notice the other day?
That Raj, you shitbag, 1-0 Man City. Raj was meant to be here today.
Yeah.
He was all excited and his letters down and just didn't bother at all. He even tried to get Jeff Arsenal on wearing some kind of phone jacker ski mask. But no.
I think you were asleep the other day, Danny, but
I was asleep.
But I changed the WhatsApp group picture to the picture of you in the bath. It was very quickly changed.
Quickly.
Very quickly. And
for everyone's betterment.
Although, actually, I might change it again now. Because I've got quite a good one now, so I'll change it while I'm here.
It's like my friend Taylor once said, hate is going to hate.
Yeah. We need to get rid of that pirate piss
cake. Potato is going to potato. Right. Potato hate is gonna potato hate.
Shut up. Potato. Have a look at the have a look at the new WhatsApp group picture, boys.
I can't. I've got Dora licking me for tongue.
I'm somewhat hating how far back we're pinned at the moment.
Yes.
Since we're we should talk watching about football, we might as well talk about it.
Talk about the game that's just...
Like Raj says, you're not commentating, that's why.
We're not commentating. Fuck that shit.
Oh, yeah, Natasha Nunes, hang on. Aren't you guys supposed to be commentating on the game? Come on, you wankers. That's from a young lady.
Trinidadian young lady as well.
Is it?
Mm-hmm. That's a boring girl.
Oh, hello, boring girl.
Over to Nima Kalis.
Hmm?
Not a cliche. Back up to Fernandinho. Long ball over the top to Aguero. Heads it back to some hang twat on. For City. Is offside.
One cunt nice. Passes to another cunt. Another is cunt's offside. Lots of cunts.
Happy?
There we go.
Is everybody happy with that?
What you need yes. to do, repeat after me, bat, cat, yeah,
cat,
mat,
racist,
mat,
twat, it's not twat, no, twat,
no, in America it's twat,
no, it's English,
no, it's twat,
we invented America. The language,
No, I don't speak English, I speak American, #American,
go change your diaper,
spell M-U-R-C-A-N,
I can't actually see what's going on the telly because I'm so far away from it.
Somebody made a good point on Twitter last night where they said that if Bilic gets to play with Coquelin, we'll have Cocklick in midfield.
Yes.
I like that. Cocklick. Childish humour.
Up the arse to Cocklick!
So the massive debate this week has not been about all the multi-million pound players we're going to sign. It's whether some prepubescent teenager is going to be sat on the bench. Dora, fuck off.
He was never going to be on the bench because we haven't completed the signing yet. These fucking idiots that were ITK last night. Oh, we'll be in the squad. Well, that's fine. He's not even signed, you dickheads. Not that
plus the fact that he technically was, he was worth technically multi-millions. Two million is more than one.
I do like, it's so typically Arsenal that we went to Poland just to haggle over, like, a couple of £100.
Over £2.50.
Yeah, £500K or something. It's like, you know, the way they were talking, it was like we'd offered £10 and they wanted £14 million, and it was like £500,000. Oh, for fuck's sake.
We should just send Danny, since his rate per hour is higher than your rate per hour, or Gim's rate per hour.
Jesus.
Over the couches. I mean, that 250, yeah. That's good work for 30 minutes on the phone.
250.
Danny's an expensive booking. Go on, Nacho.
Sanchez. Oh. He's on 10 minutes 48, 49,
yeah.
50.
Yeah.
So it's saying go on Nacho when it's Sanchez with the ball?
Because that's the position Nacho should have been in, and I looked at his number, and I was like, no, that's not him.
I put my glasses on, because now I can actually see in HD.
Chris, we're actually going to get into some discussion. I don't feel Nacho should be in that position. I would rather him be at the corner of the 18.
Yeah.
That way he can get back quicker, because he's slow as shit.
I'd rather him be playing left-back in the left-back position defending.
I was going to say, don't suggest our full-back shouldn't be on the edge of the opposition penalty area. That's not how we play.
Yeah, that's why it was... Was it 6-3 last time?
Uh-huh.
Oh, God, Santi. Oh, little twinkle toes.
What a beautiful little man that is.
Am I too loud, people? I have a habit of doing that. I'm either too loud or too quiet.
Yeah, you're right.
No, you're all right. Am I too loud or too quiet?
No, you're fine.
Good ball.
You're American. You can never be too loud, American.
American? Well, I don't know. Have you watched Perez Hilton?
What a little prick. I tell you, he's going to be the first person to hang himself live on Big Brother.
He's a cock, isn't
he?
What was all that shag in the window about the other night?
Because he's an attention-seeking...
Fuck.
Is he a lover of men? What's... I'm not sure.
I believe he is a lover of penis. Yeah.
I believe he is. The funny thing is, the one American on the show doesn't fucking watch the one American show you were talking about because he doesn't want his IQ to drop.
Oh, but it's fun, Jace, because it's like Geordie Shore. If you watch it makes you feel fun. Better about your own life, you see.
Oh, Akib is asking how we all are.
My life.
Akib! We're all good, thanks.
Girl, please, she looks,
biting me because she's hungry, because there's no food and she's fat.
Is Gail Clichy off the Muslim faith?
I'm great right
genuine
now,
question.
I read that there was one the other day that converted recently that I was quite shocked. Well, I don't know why anyone would want to change from one to the other.
He's very Muslimic in his looks now, with the beard.
Yeah, with the beard. I've got rid of my beard. That's the first time I've not had a beard in 2 years.
I was tempted the other day, but I chose not to.
Is Muslim the hipster religion? Like everybody in the 1800s and 1900s wanted to be Catholic.
Oh God!
Now everybody wants to be Muslim. Does it shift through that? Like is that the progression of things?
Yeah, it's like when being a lesbian was fashionable and girls all went for it. It's like that's.
Oh, great days.
Great days.
I've always been a lesbian.
I'm quite popular with the atheist religion. I'm quite a fan of that one myself.
I'm an agnostic atheist. Even if I see it, I won't believe it.
I worship the good church of Arsenal, and that's about it.
No, that's I will admit, to the dismay of some, I do believe
in the Christian religion. At the same time, I don't believe that Jesus or God wants me to be a stupid fucking idiot and hate everybody else. I never saw that in the Bible.
Do you know how many versions of Christianity there have been since the dawn of mankind?
Lots.
40,000.
11 billion.
40,000 individual ones that are slightly different from the last one.
There you go, then.
And they're all very naughty boys.
I am not the Messiah.
I'm not a naughty boy.
70% possession for shitting. Jesus.
You shitens thing. I thought they said Nasu was out.
He's not playing, is he? No, I don't think he's playing. No, he's not. They got Silver.
He's not even on the bench, I don't think.
I'm constantly amazed that when I put glasses on, how fantastic everything looks. I've been missing the African Cup of Nations.
I haven't bothered.
I've now updated my Firefox from version 28 to version 36.
Ooh.
Because they kept fucking with it, and you couldn't have all the menu bar the way I like it. And now I checked it last night, and it works.
How did Can get on last night? They went in front, didn't they? Did they?
I don't know.
You don't know? Well, you're fucking.
I didn't get out of bed till about 8 o'clock yesterday, and then I dropped my dinner all over the floor. The air was blue.
Sorry. It just amuses me. I know it's cruel.
I had Tesco's fresh jacket potatoes, and I microwaved them because they're lovely like that. And then I put a tin of tuna on them, and then I went to get the salad cream out of the cupboard, had my food on my lap. As the cupboard opened, it hit the food, landed on my feet, and then went all over the floor. And my Sean went, well, it's okay. I'll just make you another one.
Oh,
so I hit
no.
the cupboard. I swore a bit, but I was having a bit – I was very tired. My shoulders were achy.
Jesus, they won 4-1 against Ram, or Reams, as you call them.
Ram!
Yeah, Roberge, Privat.
I've not even looked at yesterday's goal scorers. I went and did some retweeting of the stuff. Did Sanogo score?
No, he did all right. I noticed a load of people.
I am going to go and put Sanogo in my fantasy football team from next week.
Let's not go over the top.
I am. He will get a goal every 3 games.
Yeah, that's probably fair.
Dwight Gale scored. Peterborough legend. Ex-Arsenal youth player.
The mighty Lorion one as well. Yeah, boy.
All right, easy Tiger.
Rafa Guerrero. What a legend.
Have a look at the Barnet. See, Khan won.
And against 4-1.
Reams.
And Stuart Fraud Pierce managed to win a game for Nottingham Forest. That was good.
Hold on, we won and we're still 1 point clear at the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
Has anyone got anything interesting to say in the group? Well, they all fucked off. It's almost 4-6-0. Giroud is playing too deep from Kyle Walker. I think he's trying to link it all up, though, isn't he?
Yeah, he is.
What's Kyle Walker got to do with this?
Carl, not Kyle.
Oh, sorry. Sorry.
How dare you?
So when we are, I know. So when we have possession, or when we gain possession deep in our half, you will notice that when we push back, he is so close to the midfield due to trying to link everything up so that we can actually get some momentum in numbers forward, which I don't blame him for, but at the same time, it would be nice to have somebody with a little more pace that could maybe stretch the defense a little bit more in that position. But I still think Giroud was the right choice for this game.
It's 4-2-3-1 looking at it, because Aller is playing deeper alongside Cocker. There we go. I thought Ramsey would. But
out wide. Go on, Santi! Sanchez, I mean, God, son, let's take on six of them. Come on, fucking score! Aye, God, this bastard!
Calm down, dear.
Oh, it's only a commercial. I'm gonna have to move my microphone.
We should talk about the fact that Bellerin kept his place, Coquelin kept his place, Ospina kept his place. Good, I say, because I was sure that Chambers would come in.
Very good.
for Coconut. For
I think a game like this, Chambers would come in, get booked, get sent off before the first half was over.
Go on then. Go on then.
You're still alive, child.
Go on then. Oh.
I think the offspring's died.
I've just disconnected the headphones, so I can't hear.
Okay. That's not good.
What was I doing?
I think he should do better, you know. Is this Bellerin? Yeah. Whose cross is this? Bellerin?
He has to score.
Sanchez's cross. I think he should do better. He gets there first.
That's Ox crossing.
Ox. Look, that's... well, I suppose he's under challenge, in fairness, but he does get there first.
One of the best centre-backs playing football.
Isn't that... Was that Fernando or Fernandinho that was marking him there? He's the one who likes to...
On the floor with him.
Kick people's heads off.
I don't think it matters which ones. They're both twats.
Mm.
Twats.
I thought
twats
it was Denny the twat.
Did you hear my rant the other day about you lot ringing 911?
Yes.
No, quick, someone ring 911. Okay, 911. How can I help? I don't know. They just told me to ring it. In this country, we say ring the police, the fire brigade, or the ambulance.
Go on.
Oh, he's done a punch and back in. Oh.
Take him on. Take him on.
Score from there. I'd score from there.
Here we go.
Take him on, Rambo. Take him on. That's a foul. Nice.
Oh, whiff away.
Oh, a soft foul.
City have had all the ball, but they haven't done fuck all with it, have they?
Fuck.
Oh, Aaron.
Trying too hard right there.
Remember what that stat that the Guardian podcast said, that Man City haven't won a game without Yaya in almost a year.
One man making a team and all that.
Oh, PSV won 1-0. Bastards.
Away at Vitesse.
I want PSV to lose, so then Ajax win four. Is it four in a row? No one's ever won four Dutch titles in a row.
New. With Dennis on the bench.
Yeah. On the bench? Oh, yeah. I thought he meant as a substitute.
No, he's probably good enough, to be fair.
Yeah. Thanks for telling me what job he does there, because I had no idea.
Oh, really? Right. I thought he was an ice cream man.
Well, he is. Sunday,
fuck it, Barnet lost.
Yeah.
This team in London lost a shitty, stinky, stink of fish Grimsby. You...
Still top, though, aren't they?
Yeah. Only by 5 points.
Argyle lost at home to Luton as well.
John Akindi. He's got 22 goals in 31 games. It's not too bad.
John Akindi, yeah.
I've seen better. Fuck that guy.
Naturally.
That Kolarov doesn't look like he should be a footballer. He looks like he should be in prison for horse molesting. He's done some kind of dodgy films to make money.
I was going to say something, then you put me off. Did you see Falcao's miss yesterday?
It was beautiful.
I love how they tried to justify it when defender got a touch. He's like, oh, defender got a small touch. It doesn't matter. He could have put it. He's fucking horseshit. $30 million loan.
He looked like a baby deer on ice trying to stand for the first time. It was fucking epic.
And there is no way that man is 29. No way. He's at least 35.
You know, you can measure how old someone is by the density of the bones in their little finger.
I didn't, but you are a fountain of knowledge.
When there was a recent World Youth Cup and Nigeria went there and they had a squad of 23, and then when they announced they were going to do this test... 14 of the players went and don't know, we're not playing.
No, we won't bother. We'll give this one a miss, lads.
Nice.
Here we go. See if we've got some more messages. Oh, we have. We've got Jarvis Jarvoulier. Pronounce my last name, GF. Oh, there you go. Jarvoulier. For some reason, German and French sounding names. I've got a.
It's going to be a running joke because you get different people every week now.
Akib says ball bag.
Poor hairy ball bag. I feel so sorry for that gentleman. You lot ripped him, bless him.
Dan 170514.
It was Bulbeck, by the way.
That's the date we won the FA Cup, wasn't it? I would bring Walcott on in the second half. Well,
we're only 20 minutes in the first half.
Carl Walker says we need an outlet of some sort. What do you mean, like the ABW need a shop?
Like a cat flap.
Yeah, I've got a spare cat flap. How long is the delay?
I will say,
a few minutes. FK should get on this one. Oh, FK's on a sabbatical.
There's a
referee! Penalty!
You pig.
Yes.
Get on that, Joe.
Who's going to miss it?
Penalty.
Sanchez, do not touch that fucking ball.
Santi, it's got to be Santi. Monreal does really well. That is Good, company. Yeah, good.
Don't look in the box to chat window because they'll give away whether they've scored because they're all fuckers. Fucking we're on 22 minutes, 44, 45, that 46, okay. 47.
So that fucking cunt that is acts like he's backing away,
you know
sticks
what?
His leg out, and then acts like he didn't do anything.
They
fuck
get,
him.
People come get away with that. People come get away with that week man. In, week out. And is that Mike Reed?
Yes.
Give a fuck me. It's a cold hell has just frozen over.
Mike Reed, referee, says, wait for it, wait for it.
Mike Reed was in EastEnders.
Yeah, I know, but they used to do run around.
Yeah, I know. Go on, Santi. Please, go on, Santi. Go on, Santi.
Yes!
Yes! Yes! Get in!
Get your fucking
Santi.
Fucking way out! Go on,
Santi.
My knees when we score.
I'm seriously a second in front of y'all. Which you guys actually don't know because I'm on Wi-Fi, which is delaying my feed, which makes this perfect.
Oh, dear.
But every time I've said something, you guys have said the same thing a second later. Pretty funny.
We all thought it's just because you know more than we do. Look at Mr. M. Did you see on FIFA the price of Mezet last night has dropped drastically on FUT? I was picking up Mezets for 5,000. I bought 6 of them.
Oh, now you tell me. Well, I haven't got enough fucking coins to buy anyone, so it's irrelevant for me.
I had 30,000.
Oh, well, I've got 5,000, so...
I don't play video games because I'm not cool.
I've
been playing video games since 1981. penalty. Still kicking off.
I sold my PS3 a couple years ago to pay for some crack, so I haven't really played any games since then.
The price
all right,
of crack.
All right, give me. Danny, I got the WWE Network today.
What? What's that?
The network where you can stream everything live, and they've got all the back catalogue online.
Oh, the $9.99 jobby.
Yes.
The wrestling.
Yeah.
Oh.
Good.
Yes, Jace. I'm still 12.
Are you thinking my position?
It's not as good as it used to be, but they've put the pay-per-view price up on Sky now to £20, so I thought, well, I might as well just get a network for a tenner, it's easier.
I still remember when it was, like, what was it, Wolfpack versus somebody
NWO.
Else?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The old days.
Classic.
Classic old school.
We're 1-0 up against Man City, people, for fuck's sake.
I know we are.
How's that happened?
Because they've had all the ball, and really they've done not a lot with it, to be honest.
Would it be bad form to get all 11 players and just line them up in front of our goal and just stand there for the next 60 minutes, 80
yes,
minutes?
It would be, because we probably put it in our own net.
I've actually thought about that before, Danny, and I don't understand why people don't just get, like, the tallest team you can buy in each position, and on free kicks, just stand everybody in front of the goal with the arms behind their back.
Kenny Sampson's just followed the podcast account.
Has he?
Yeah.
Is that Kenny Sampson of that was homeless a while ago?
Yeah, I think that was slightly more twisted for publicity reasons by certain people, not necessarily him.
No.
To make him look like legend, now homeless.
I don't think he would twist it.
Go, Alexis.
No, he didn't. No. The people that were reporting on it to try and make it sound worse than it was. Although he was in a bit of a situation and... luckily now he's okay, and I think he said he might even come on. But he was. I remember the first time I started supporting Arsenal back in the. Oh, when I first had an Arsenal picture, it was the 85-86 season, and I saw Kenny Sampson there, and I thought he was Asian. He had a big, thick moustache, and he'd obviously been on holiday, and he looked like he was Asian. I thought. I didn't know Asian.
I'm
going to go and find the picture, and then you'll see what I mean.
Kenny Sampson.
So I actually have a stat through 23 minutes. City passing. City's passing 175 of 204 to Arsenal 66 of 87. So definitely City are bossing the ball right now.
You got percentage on that.
So they're bossing the ball, but anything with it? They haven't done anything with it. They can pass. They can do this all game, as far as I'm concerned. All of this shit, pass it, across the... There we go, across
Chris,
again.
That's very irritating, Chris.
What?
You haven't got the display on your box turned off for the display that when you've got it on pause and it's playing, all the little circles going around. You can turn that off.
What?
You know on your Skybox, see the little blue circle going round and round the front of the box?
Yes.
You can turn all that off so you've got no fucking annoying, distracting lights.
Don't look at it.
I'm not. I'm just saying in general. Turn mine off.
Okay. Well, I don't know how, so.
You just hit it. You got a hammer.
You just smash it. Well, I very rarely watch stuff in delay, so it doesn't usually affect me. But because you've made me put my feedback, I've had to.
If people wanted to do a little catch-up, we're at 27 minutes, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57. So what you do, you find out where we were and then just pause it to around there.
Carl Jenkins in the line.
And I am.
It is.
Look at that.
I'm 3 seconds ahead of you, actually, on my feed.
No attempts on target. No attempts, none on target. We've had 2 attempts, 1 on target.
So did you have percentages for those past completions, Jace?
I did not have percentages because I'm not Stephen Hawking, and I can't do math that fast.
What are you talking about?
Well, you have been counting them up, have you, sir? You're nicking it from a site. You're nicking a living.
I am.
You're nicking a living. Was...
All right, well, if I was getting paid, then yes, I would be. I'm not. I will credit that to 442.com.
Boom.
There you go.
Attribution must be had.
Read some more comments, Danny.
Yes. Where are we? We're on this. Joe Maggi's there. Zach Buddy. I think he said Buddle then.
It's Bud, isn't it?
Yeah. And Jarvis Javulia says Santi. Natasha says, oh, Santi Karzula. KZ Corner says, yes, yes, yes. Natasha says, Monreal of all people gets the good call, amazing. And then she says, Cock doing the business so far, good for him. Yes. Mm-hmm. Hopefully we could win this now. Now that we're winning.
Oh, now you change your fucking
tune. If we draw, I shall say we could draw.
Exactly. Thursday night, you were predicting fucking 8-0 City.
Oh, look at Mert. Oh, look, he's fucking silky skills.
I know our good friend Mr. Jason Davies will love this. Wasn't it 7-0 at the weekend, Mr. Carpenter?
I don't know, mate. That was a week 7-0 ago.
Forgot. Been made null and void, they're all on steroids.
Yeah, it's completely irrelevant now.
Jarvis says, Jason Ramsey so far. Anyway.
Huh?
What do you think to Ramsey so far, Jarvis?
He looks sharp.
Javulier.
He's given the ball away a couple of times, but he looks sharp.
I think still a little bit of rust there coming back, which is expected, but nothing terrible. I actually probably would have liked to have seen Rizicki start this game.
Yeah, I was surprised.
Big game
didn't.
Tom. Exactly. Especially how well he's played
in these larger
fixtures like this.
Go on, Alexis.
Nice. They're all over the fucking place.
Well done, Rambo. Yeah, I've been impressed how we've played because, okay, we haven't had much of the ball, but you don't... Possession's overrated. That's Barcelona. You don't always need the ball.
The goals are overrated.
should we shoot more? You don't always need the ball to be
round?
No, to be in control of the game. You know, if what we're doing here now is fine. Just keep the ball in that area, go backwards, that's absolutely fine. City have had it, but it's been all in front of our 18-yard box.
Anyone believe in subliminal advertising? You people with Pepsi want to sponsor us? Oh, look, I'm so refreshed now. I've just drank some lovely Pepsi Max. The aspartame in there will kill me before I'm 60.
I have a can or two every day. In fact, I have a can of energy drink every day.
Yeah, it's nice. You can afford to. I can't. It's too many calories.
I can afford to. Says Mr. Fucking overseas, Money over here. Jesus.
If you're overseas or anything, please support Carolina Railhawks, FC, second division team in North Carolina here in the States. They also happen to be my employer.
Cheap plug.
So please, no, not even cheap, just
shameless
expensive.
Plugging.
We have all adopted them as our second team.
I have no. Please do. Please go. Please buy a shirt. We'll ship anywhere in the world. And that'll be greatly appreciated, especially the fact in March, special insider information, in March, we will be revealing our new kit, which I specifically designed.
Is it red?
Did you really? Are you lying?
It is not red. I did. No, I did. Yeah, I'm in charge of that. So I'm in charge of all merchandise and team gear.
Serious question, Jace. Do you get to have a hand in the design even though Adidas produced the shirts? Do you get a hand in producing the actual shirts then?
So the way Adidas has us do it, they have a lot of different templates that we can use, but we can customize the color
and sort of the layout of the colors on the actual template. So we used one of their pre-existing templates, and then I just laid out the colors and the type of color that it would be, where the colors would go, things like that.
Cool. So, isn't it all orange and blue?
This year, a little extra insight for you guys. It will be orange and white.
Ooh, as in Houston Dynamo esque.
As in Miami Fusion. No, as in Miami Dolphins old away kit.
Houston Dynamo, Danny. Yes. Get your time.
No, I maybe seven old.
Orange and white will be the kit color. It will be an orange and white top, orange and white shorts, and then orange and white socks.
Lovely, so, very Dutch.
Orange, because orange is the color of insanity.
It's the new black. Orange is the new black.
It is the new black. Oh,
that's good.
I've seen that show. I've heard good things.
Nah, nor have I. The Offspring's seen it and loves it. Well, maybe what we should do. Do you want the podcast to sponsor you? Because that could mean about £300 or £400 a year you might get.
I think I'll stick with our 50 to 100K a year that we get from our current sponsor in an insurance company called Blue Cross Blue Shield out of North Carolina.
They sound very impressive. I've heard nothing but good things about them. I haven't. I'm just being nice.
For $15,000,
yeah.
you can have a sleeve.
Ooh.
And how much for a whole shirt? That's a bit steep. I thought our shirts at £60 are expensive. You want $15,000 for a sleeve?
We're still trying to make up our mind whether we're going to keep the same kits for next year for Pirates.
Of course you are.
Well, no, we're going to keep the same, subject to sponsorship, of course. But we're going to keep the same home shirt, but I'm tempted to have a yellow away kit.
Stop spending money you haven't got.
No, but
you
if we
be wearing that kit players, in a decade.
The players will pay for it, you donut. But if we had a yellow kit, then we'd be proper Arsenal colours.
Yeah, and how many Arsenal players have you got playing for the team? Two, three?
Don't care. I run the team. I can choose what colours we wear. End of story.
What if you get relegated?
Fuck off, eh?
What if you get relegated?
I'll just play on my own in the garden.
I think maybe now that Jason is a part of the podcast, we should our results round up every week. Just let everyone know how the Redhawks are getting on.
Yes, I think we should. Yeah, I agree.
That'd be a good idea, yeah. Jace.
Absolutely. They would be a little bit... no offense, Kris. We're a little bit better than the Barbican Pirates.
Outrageous. Outrageous.
We have contended for our championship or a playoff spot every single year.
Oh, so, yeah. He comes in, throws his weight around, Pirates get shoved on the shelf. I see how it goes.
Is Nacho Novo
I will say, we will put the Pirates... Nacho Novo through 2015, yes. So you can get your customized Nacho Novo Carolina Railhawks kits by going to carolinarailhawks.com and then selecting shop.
Or you can all put some money into a pot and buy Kris Carpenter a 30-second birthday present for next Sunday, which is my birthday, and send it to me. That's what you can do.
Or you can get me a 30-second birthday present, post it back to 2002.
50-second. And you need a big one.
Is that the Greg Shields he used to play for Arsenal? Assistant coach?
No, it's
ex-Hibs.
It's not the same Greg Shields. He did not play for Arsenal. No. It is the Sam Stockley. Sam Stockley is one of our assistant coaches.
He just
helped out Kris on a bunch of coaches.
Yes.
Stuff. No, different stock.
Some awesome
came up
stuff.
Through the Southampton Academy. And then also we've got Stefan Oakes, who was sort of a
Luton.
Consultant, and he coaches a lot.
Leicester.
Leicester, midfielder.
Leicester City. Mm-hmm. Yes. So funny story, he told me when he found out I was an Arsenal fan, he was he started in midfield for Leicester City in 2003 to 2004 against the Invincibles. He said he got pulled at halftime because he was so awful and said, he goes, if you had ever played against Vieira, you would be happy to be pulled at halftime as well. He said it's the only time he's been subbed off that he was happy to come off at halftime because he said he was getting
dismantled. He's not going to book him for that. Wow.
Unfucking believable. Does everybody like my Ramsey, by the way? This is what I'm calling this right here. This is my Ramsey.
I don't have hair. I hate you.
a nice flow.
I could have gotten over that many years ago.
My hairline's gone south. No, south, north, north. It's gone backwards.
Who was it? Barry Glendening kept saying on the Guardian podcast that Arsenal would definitely beat Man City, no two ways about it.
He said he had a feeling, yeah.
That might be
Dan. Right a few times. Yes. There's a long way to go, Danny. There's a long way to go.
I'm just surprised we're not losing already.
Oh, there's the happy cheer for Danny we all know and love.
I'll see if you lot are putting anything in the window. Defenders are doing well. Yeah, Carl. Akib says Ramsey's trying too much. Carl Walker, the Ox is a bit quiet. Matthew AFC, Sir Oliver Giroud OBE. Matthew, signings on deadline day, Kris. Francis Jeffers on a free. Jeffers is retired now, I think.
Mm. He's coaching somewhere, I think, yeah.
He's had a bit of a hard time of living up to the reputation, which is a...
We'll have him at the Pirates.
Yeah. Mm. Hawks v Pirates, pre-season friendly from Carl Walker.
We've talked about this. I could ever afford to get all of my boys to America, we would do it.
Get them to come over here.
I'm sure they'd love to come to Plymouth.
Yeah. That's where they'll come from in the first place. That's where they left from.
Oh dear!
Get him to come back.
Showpiece occasion that would be, and a very. I will say,
in defense of the Railhawks, we've beaten the LA Galaxy 3 years running now, the equivalent to the FA Cup, what's called the US Open Cup. We have beat them. We even beat the likes of the Roy Keanes and the Landon Donovans all came this year.
Yeah,
they were tired of losing us 2 years in a row, and we whooped their fucking ass.
That friendly with the Pirates, Jace, yeah, scrap that.
Someone told me about a podcast, two English blokes in America, two blokes in suits or something.
Oh, men in suits.
Oh, it's very... But they did a really good interview with... That's it. They did a really good interview with Landon Donovan. I like Landon Donovan even more than I used to like him.
Landy cakes.
Landon is a great guy. Little side story. I've been nutmegged by Landon Donovan.
haven't we all?
I was setting up our stadium for their game and was walking by him as he was doing a fitness test, and he just happened to judge my steps right, nutmegged me off of the sidewalling on the stadium, and it came back to him, and I just sort of said, "Oh, you like that, don't you?" And he goes, "I love it." I said, "Well, keep on doing it, just not tonight, my friend." And he just sort of laughed. So that's been my interaction with Landon.
And what would have happened if he'd have done that once to our other Jason Davis? It'd have been Landon Donovan RIP.
I will say the fact that Landon Donovan actually played almost any this season is a miracle. If you would have seen him in his fitness test, his knee was wrapped, ankles were both wrapped. He's got an exam.
Why did he not book him for the penalty? Shut up, company, you egg-faced twat. Fuck off.
Has anybody seen Mystery Science Theater 3000?
No.
No.
What is it?
It's tough to describe. It's a movie about a guy and two robots watching movie and making snarky comments throughout the... And they're all like bad sci-fi movies that they watch.
Is it Is it set place in a cinema?
Somewhat, yes.
I mean, do they sit like in seats in a cinema, just the three of them?
So it's actually based at they have been captured by an evil doctor who sent them into space, and he's put this movie theater in this space station and is forcing them to watch the worst movies ever made. And then they just sit there and comment sarcastically and snidely on the movies. Well, if you watch the full feature version of Mystery Science Theater 3000, you'll understand exactly what Vincent Company looks like with the big four-headed aliens.
No.
Mars Attacks is what I call Company.
Very similar to that.
I heard what you call Company. It's quite rude.
Well, he's a bell end, isn't he? Silence.
Isn't he a Bellin that you would like to have in your team because he's a decent defender?
No, that is all. You know what? That is no, he's not. That is all he is.
Oh, here we go. Sorry.
That is all he is. He's decent.
Messi, overrated as well.
No, he is. He's definitely overrated. Yeah. He is. Well, why did he play for Hamburg for so many years? He's very good, but he.
Why did Mertesacker play in Germany for so many years before coming here?
Well, Mertesacker's not overrated, though, is he?
You couldn't get through security.
People talk about company like he's one of the best defenders in the world. Diego Godin, he wouldn't even tie his fucking shoelaces.
Oh,
the
only captain.
The thing with company is he's popular because he shouts a lot.
He's a bit shouty,
and he makes last-ditch tackles, which usually is a result of him making a fuck-up.
Our back four running in a straight line, almost, apart from Mertesacker, who's keeping everyone onside.
Like they practiced it.
I'm not saying company shit, by the way. I'm just saying he's not as good as everyone says he is. Good tackle,
oh,
Bellerin.
He's just
pulled
him down.
Well done. That's a foul. Poor in James Milner.
Fuck Milner.
Don't walk out of defence, you twat. Oof it.
I don't think he could, there, to be honest. Well done. We need to hold this to half time. We don't want to be conceding now.
This is one of the. I will say, most of this first half, with as much as they've had the ball, I felt somewhat comfortable with having the ball.
They're playing in front of us.
Exactly. When you're not really comfortable with us not having possession, but this game. And who would have fucking thought that it would have been against City that we would have been this comfortable with them having possession of the ball?
They're going to get Aguero into the game. That's the worry for me. He's done nothing thus far, but they'll get him into the game at some point.
I think if Milner would have fallen on Bellerin, it'd have killed him.
Fat bastard.
The issue with Aguero is he has to have a little bit of space. We've denied all the space that he typically uses.
Exactly.
And so I think we've done a very good job defensively. At the same time, we've got to keep it up in the second half. And in John Colton's defense, John has always said we're a second half team, and we really are. We really push on and get much more into a flow and a rhythm in most games in the second half, which I'm looking forward to see. In this game, glad that we can actually talk about this game while we're watching it instead of just our pathetic lives.
Speak for yourself. I firmly believe that if we don't concede a goal, we'll win this game.
Are we doing, once the game is over, are we doing any kind of thing straight up? Or once the game's over, are we going home?
Are we going home? Well, I don't mind.
I'm home. I'm home.
We can do an hour. Maybe not a two-hour session, but just a brief.
I'm fine with that.
There you go. We've got Zach Buddy has said, City appear to have sold seats for this game then, unlike usually.
There's plenty of empty seats, Zach, trust me.
No. It's just people dressed up as seats. They're going to announce a song. And people have actually dressed as a seat in the Etihad.
The oily had.
So I will say the Men in Blazers, because of the MLS debacle with Frank Lampard and his transfer, have started to call Manchester City parent company. Which I find fucking hilarious.
I really hate when I hear English people going to America and then not speaking the Queen's English. They're filling it full of right nows and calling
well
it
done,
soccer.
Well done, don't well do done. Cochrane's just gone radio rental. I like that.
Yeah, I'm watching him.
Yep.
Well
Look
done.
At him. He's almost foaming.
Hey, you! Fuck off! I fucking kill you!
But I do like my American soccer, and I will call it soccer because that's what it's called over there. And I've been watching it for years. And
soccer ball.
Every podcast I do, always try to get a little bit in about the mighty Portland.
Wait,
go on, Santi, have a shot. Chris Wood, it would go in. I thought he was going to
do this.
Happy day.
I told you three beers before halftime, and I'm almost done. Slightly buzzed. But
happy day.
That doesn't mean I don't have more in the fridge.
Santi's nipples.
Oh, he's all nipply. Hello. Oh,
I got a semi.
Everybody's nipple.
At Ibiza Clubber just tweeted us and said, "You lot cracking me up as usual. Love the podcast. Keep it up, lads. Hashtag I am.
Thank you, sir.
Have I?
Well, it's because you're lazy, Joey.
No, I've been looking at the chat window.
Graham Souness slept rough last night.
He's got it, isn't he? They all do it.
Fucking mong.
He's been on the meth. Blake Collier has just retweeted us. Thank you, Blake Collier. We're already following you. If there's anybody here who we're not following, you just let us know. You don't have to follow us. Artan Sinini, Sinani, are we following him? No, you're an egg, so we can't follow you if you're an egg. And it looks like we've bought followers. So we'll only follow people if you're not an egg. Kenny Sampson. Ida Marvin, are we following you? You are from Iceland.
Oh, awesome.
Home of the Giants.
Follow, and
he's
that
got
man.
Joe Rogan in his fucking, in his avatar and his bio.
That man. I like to give love to the Scandinavians.
I love that place.
If I were to choose one place to live, it would probably be Sweden or Norway. I really like Norway, actually.
Sweden is the most beautiful place on earth.
Oh, man.
I spent 3 weeks there years ago, and it is just so beautiful.
I have never been there, but every picture that I see, and then when I read stuff about like their government and how happy their people are, I'm like,
how beautiful they are.
Why did I crack in the wall?
Why did I? Oh man,
Daddy, can we have a podcast day out to Sweden, please?
Oh, Mark, 71 AFC, ambulance driver, bouncer, 100% guru. He's given us a little cheeky retweet.
Yeah, I think he gave me a follow last night.
Yeah, and me, I noticed that.
I will follow him back because he does speak a lot of sense. But I need to lose somebody before I follow because I can't have odd numbers of followers.
I only follow people that I've spoken to.
Yeah,
I will say a great tweet is from Sabubin Gurner. Oh my God,
Suburban Gooner,
yes, Kris, yes. Who said, "What I'm liking about Cock is that he's winning headers in the middle of the park. We never do that." That's a great point,
yeah,
I think.
Absolutely, yeah.
We've actually finally got somebody in there.
Keep going through tweets, Jace. Doesn't matter who they're from.
Yeah.
I'll give people.
I'm
a
just
look
looking at that Duncan Isaac Ellis. He says, "I throw shapes for fun."
Messy Minutes, who are an awesome. Anybody that doesn't follow Messy Minutes, please do, because although they are a generic football account, they're all Arsenal fans. They've just tweeted the best thing has been our tactical outlook. It appears to be, for once, specifically set up to counter the threats presented. Finally, and he's right, absolutely right.
Will Ben at Vengerboy 1 just tweeted the three main question marks: Bellerin, Coughlin, and Ramsey. All doing a good job so far. Impressive team performance.
Absolutely. Guna Girl at Arsenal Mine. Over to you, Soonis, you fucking wanker. Like that one. maybe after my own heart there. What else we got here? Hugh Wizzy, friend of the pod. Actually in love with Coughlin, making crucial challenges, screaming orders. What a guy.
Did you send that to us?
No, this is just generic ones off time.
Oh, okay.
James Ralph Stokes of the Goonosphere, Goonosphere House. Lecoq is hard. Long live Lecoq. Yes.
Is Simi Saville watching?
Simi Saville? I have no idea.
That's what they call him, isn't it? If you heard the last pod, they kept coming up with new names for him.
When have they started?
Rob Parrott, who never ever fails not to FF me. He's an absolute god, that man. Company should be off, I agree. Rob Parrott.
Sounds familiar.
Yep, Rob Parrott's great follow. Great
He's
follow.
Lovely guy.
Paul Swain at Paul Swain AFC78. Bellerin has been excellent as well. Everyone seems to think he's not great defensively. Perhaps it's the way he's being asked to play. Hashtag Arsenal.
Mm-hmm. Tell the Gooner. Tell's usually a miserable sod, but today he's been quite positive. So far, very good. Need to keep the discipline without the ball. Look on the counter. Much, much better than expected, but a long way to go. So he's still got a negative in at the end.
Another North American here, Andrew McVicker from Drew in Ottawa, or at Drew in Ottawa, says, "As it stands, I prefer Cock to Arteta and Flamini." I think that's a decent discussion point right now with the form of those three.
Friend of the pod, FK, the best 45 minutes I've seen us play in recent years. Defending as a team, and you have to say, Coquelin looks assured. Only half time, mind. Yeah, fair point. Very fair point. I think Coughlin's done really well. He's earned his place.
Yep. Keep him.
Stay there.
But the people are asking, that was one of the questions during the week's pod, is he good enough just for the rest of the season, or do you reckon he could improve and be the man for next season, because stranger things have happened.
Ooh, Coughlin.
I will say, Go ahead.
No, go on.
I will say, Rochester Gooners up in Rochester, New York, great first half and great turnout. Over 40 Gooners in Rochester right now watching the match.
And what time is it?
Come on, you Gooners.
In Rochester, right now it's 11:52, so noon.
Fuck that.
But it's still a.
So they've had to get up about 9 in the morning to get there.
It's still a great turnout there, yeah.
In Canada, it's about 10 o'clock as well. Kelly was just saying to me that apparently the reason they're wearing yellow is for commercial reasons. It was in the commentary.
Like I said.
So, all right. Even so, it's still fucking ridiculous.
How about a few stats for
another.
Go on, Chris.
This is actually a tweet and a stat all in one.
Oh.
From Orbino, who is at Orbino. Alexis Sanchez has made more tackles than any other Arsenal player this season at 42 tackles.
Who has?
So that would be Alexis Sanchez, the beautiful man.
He's made the most number of tackles out of the whole of our team.
Yes, definitely, yes.
Sake. And then let me guess, next one he's had the most fucking saves, he's that good.
Probably, yeah.
How about a few
the
stats?
The most saves from smoking in the shower.
And we've got, so far the stats, offsides, Man City have had 2, we've had none. Fouls, they've had 4, we've had 3. Corners, 4-1 to them. Throw-ins, 17-11 to them. And tackles, 14-13 to them. Pass success rate, 83-75. And possession 65-35, and what good has it done them?
Something has just made me laugh here, and it's nothing to do with Arsenal, but I have to share it.
Is that your phone going off?
Yes. There's somebody who's just retweeted this, and it's an Everton fan. And you can have that lineup app that you can download where you can put people into a lineup. Have you seen it?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, they've put an Everton lineup, and he said, "Who do you reckon we should play against West Brom tomorrow?" And he's put 11 players out, and the 11 players are named "Shit, we are fucking because point is absolutely no fucking there." And he said, "Rearrange them in whatever formation you like."
I want to give a big shout out to somebody who just followed me, who's a great friend of you guys, and his name is Akeem!
Akeem!
Who just followed me. Thank you, Akeem.
We don't have friends, Jace. We pay them off.
Yeah.
I feel like I need to open my pocketbook then. I'm going to step away because 3 beers in the first half is taking its toll, yeah. And I've got to go get my 3 beers for the second half. So okay. I will be right back. I'm sure as everybody's actually listening to Henri over there on the Sky Analysis anyway.
Graham Souness is talking bollocks at the moment.
Oh, when I was a player, I used to just fucking call them.
Aussie Guna 80 just tweeted me and said, "Do you think the new confidence at the back is down to Ospina being in the team?"
Then you can mute your phone before I come around and kill you with it.
Oh, God's sake.
So I'm fucking unprofessional.
I'm doing a Davis.
Jeff Arsenal.
Normal radio show, is it?
Friend of the pod. Original...
Founder of the pod.
I'm trying to think of the right word, right way around to put it. The
legend.
Lovely Jeff has put, "Come on, boys, keep the shape, discipline and concentration, and we can nick another on the break late on." If people are listening to this and you're wondering, why can't I type in the chat window, you have to have a Google Plus account, and then you log into your YouTube account with your Google Plus account, because I couldn't do that with the with my own GFP one. So I've got
Danny, Luca... Luca, who told us how to pronounce his name the other day.
Oh, yeah, he's told me on.
The podcast account isn't following him, so could you please sort that out?
Are we not?
No.
That's a fuck. Sorry, Luca, that's an absolute disgrace.
Blame Danny. Here he is. Hashtag Danny there out.
He is. Oh. And we'll just give him a little retweet.
There you go, thank you.
And then a little favourite. Luca Kolakusic.
Kolakusic. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because it's got this little... I thought it was a dead spider on my screen.
Kolakusic. Luka Kolakusic.
He's from Croatia, isn't he?
Bok.
Luka.
Indeed.
Bok.
Yes,
Bok. My mate Herman, who is... I tweeted Luka last night to say about my mate Herman. Herman Hrvrže. And he's trying to teach me some Croatian. And all we got to was Bok. He did teach me one that was Kakože, which was "How are you?" And when I said to Herman, "Kakože," he went, "What are you on about?" he had no idea what the fuck I was going on about.
Fair enough.
So there you go.
Keeps it people entertained.
Fuck all use.
Keeps people
I've been friends with Herman for years.
Did I hear you mention in the WhatsApp group this morning that you were chatting to a certain Swedish gentleman this morning?
Anders Limpar.
Splendid.
Yes, he said, I said, "You can come on this week if you want." And he went, "Okay, I should come on this Thursday." And then Gimli told me off because we've got other things planned for this Thursday.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So what we might do is do a pre-record.
I think that would be good.
Gimli sent him a message. Perfect, Dan. Anders says, perfect. P-E-R-F-E-K-T. There you go. A little bit perfect. Of Scandinavian there, Danny. Let Gimli contact me to sort a date. Then Anders and Gimli's it's McGimli. We're good for this Thursday if that makes it easier for you. Oh, looks like we might have Anders Limbo on Thursday. Yeah,
cool. Actually, I just want to give a quick shout out to a couple of people that just followed me. Ibiza Clubber that we mentioned earlier, that's Dwayne Ellis. And Jarvis. Did you say that it's a chap who spoke to you earlier, wasn't it, Jarvis? Jalavulaire?
Yeah, you think he's French? Or bonjour, Jarvis.
Yeah, quite possibly. He's just giving me follows. Yes, je suis en grune, vive la snull. I reckon he's French.
Actually, if people are watching, go and follow this bloke at Aussie, A-U-S-S-I-E, Guna 80. It's a bloke I've known for years on Twitter. I'm going to go and follow him in my own account. And he quit after the defeat against Chelsea.
Oh, that's Mark, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, there you go, Mark. We know who you are. So I've just followed him with a podcast account.
He just tweeted me. I think he's just come back on to Twitter, hasn't he? I think. Yeah.
He's been emailing me, even in the pod account, saying how he's doing. And
he's actually, his bio is quit Twitter following the defeat against Chelsea. Rejoin on the day we play City. Maybe following the game, I'll remember why. Good man. Welcome back, man.
Is he? Oh, he follows me. There you go. You should have told me, Mark, it was you, and I'd have followed you back. I only follow people that I've followed him, loads of people that I haven't spoken to. I say loads, maybe about 40 that I've, before this podcast shenanigans kicked off. Because before that, I only had about 700 or 800 followers. I mean, see, you got 2,000 last night. You were up to?
Yeah, I've just given him a follow. Yes, thank you to all those people. We're 2012 now, and I haven't bought any of them. So. No, I genuinely haven't. There's a few. There's probably a few spammers in there, but no, it's.
It's easy. I've got my fake account, which I'm not telling anybody what it is, and I follow nobody, and I've got 1,800 followers, and that's how easy it is. And I've only had it open for 3 months.
I take it as a huge compliment that 2,000 people give a monkey's what I have to say.
give a monkey's cuss.
But no, anyone that follows me will know that generally, unless something comes up or unless I'm busy, I will usually try and reply to everyone that tweets me. So. That doesn't mean that everyone can start tweeting me 1,000 messages. Because the more it goes up, the harder it is. But I try and reply to everyone because I like to interact with people. As long as they're nice, I don't mind.
Have you read any messages from Kyriakos Kitsi?
No, where's that?
Navas is dangerous with his pace in the YouTube account. And Joe Madge has put, do we push on the second half or sit back more? So, I don't know, maybe sit back more.
What
channel have you got on?
What, sorry?
Oh, no, I'm not watching it live. I'm watching the 30-second delay.
Yeah.
I can see a bit of your telly. You can't. It's all because of the contrast. It's all blurry.
Oh, it's an advert for Fortitude, which I'm tempted to watch. I don't know whether it's any good or not.
Oh, Christopher Eccleston. There's so many good series I've been on.
What's it about, though? I don't
testicles.
Know. There's two good films out next year that I want to see as well.
I saw one called San Andreas.
Did you?
Mad Max. I say I saw trailers.
We got Jurassic Park next year, haven't we? Yeah.
Dojo Wojak. Oh, the Royal Rumble. Is it tonight? Oh, next Saturday.
Next Sunday. My birthday, Danny. That's my birthday. Did I mention it's my birthday next Sunday?
Yeah, he did. Cool. Dojo Wack says, I fucking love winning. Kyriakos says, Coquelin replaced Flamini. Bellic replaced Arteta. And let's buy Morgan Schneidlin for the first team. Yeah, okay, fair enough.
I'm going to turn around just briefly, and I'm going to go,
there's
a man with his top out on TV. That's no good, is it? I'm going to go for a quick wee-wee, everybody, because I don't want to piddle myself, so I will return shortly.
How many beers did you get, Jace?
Three. Well, not all the beers. I have, sadly, for the longest time, our fridge practically only had beer in it, and it was full of beer. I grabbed three more for the second half, though. So cheers, everybody. I am drinking. Just to let you know what I'm drinking. If you're in North Carolina, please drink Lone Rider. This is the Sweet Josie. It's their nut brown ale. It's absolutely amazing. They are a great local brewery. I support local. I try to buy local, and this is some of the best beer ever. And my wife drinks their wheat beer, which is called Shotgun Betty. So they're all named after like Western type, old school chicks who will probably kill you, like Sweet Josie, because I think sounds like she's a prostitute and probably has the syphilis.
I'm drinking fizzy water. That's how rock and roll I am.
Oh, kickoff!
Yeah, I wonder why he went now when it's just kickoff and started. I read a few more things from the YouTube channel. Plus, he's on yellow and he's trying hard. Yeah, I think maybe, get Rambo off. See how he gets on with this half, because I think he's very eager to impress. What was the ref given there? Oh, he's telling someone off. Joe Madge says, Carl Walker, don't want him to make a mistake. Joe Madge, I would love to have seen Roz a start, to be honest. This is his type of game. Well, on the counter-attack, I think Rosicky can rip these a new one. Jarvis says, should Ozil get us on second half? Definitely. And Joe Madge says, Kris, if it's your birthday next Sunday... Is it? Yes, it is his birthday. He's mentioned it 50 times.
It's my birthday next Sunday.
Carl, all depends how the game pans out. And at Jarvis. Oh, the Oz FIFA. That's a new one. Didn't know I was watching a beer review show.
A what?
A beer review show. We have no sponsors.
I will always review stop. Beer.
Fucking hell. We don't have any sponsors and we have no one to answer to, so we talk about and show
we
and
do what we want.
Everything we like.
We do what we want.
Not that we thought you were saying we shouldn't, Oz. I know you haven't. You've been funny. Jarvis, Rambo is my worry. Yeah, I think maybe he might. He's trying maybe a little bit too hard
maybe
to impress.
Yeah, he's doing all right, though.
I think Rosicky, get Rosicky on maybe about 60 minutes, 67 minutes.
Even as it is for 10, 15, they're going to come at us hard now. We got to ride the wave for a bit.
Carl Walker, we may need to defend our lives if it's still 1-0 come 70 minutes. True.
Yeah, true. Oh. We don't want to...
How is that their advantage?
Well done. Away. Well done, Per.
What time are you up to, Jason? We're at 31, 32,
33, 35, 36,
okay, so still on the same time then.
Yeah.
Peter Reed apparently tweeted in the first half, no way a pen. What an idiot.
That's why he was a shit manager.
Yeah.
A mental case of a player.
Not even in work, is he at the moment, I don't think.
There's only a certain number of times you can fuck shit up.
Absolutely.
Stop going here. We'll give you another go.
Greetings to Prison Mech and Dark Valley G on Twitter, by the way.
I should apologise a bit for the amount of bloody tweeting of our pod that I keep just retweeting over and over. And I mean, not retweeting.
That's all right. This is very much a test, isn't it? So we need feedback. People might be offended by our bullshit talking.
Oh, here you go. Dwayne Isaac Ellis, who is at Ibiza Clubber. He looks like a clubber.
That's the one I said about the first half. I beat the clubber. Dwayne, yeah.
Yeah, he looks like he's got the look of a man who is no stranger to a big box, a little box, or a cardboard fish. He says he put a picture of his mate with Theo Walcott, and he says, my mate, in brackets City fan, stayed at the same hotel as Arsenal is in, oh, I don't know what that says. Walcott said to my mate, Arsenal will win today, hashtag believe. Dwayne knows.
He's not going to say they're going to lose.
I've just been followed by Khalid. Hello, Khalid.
I have as well.
Go on, Ox.
I don't know what he's doing.
Come inside, you're unlucky.
He's not tweeted much. Done a little bit in, I think that's Arabic he's done it in. My name, Daniel, in Arabic looks lovely. I've got an entire thing of all of my name in loads of different fonts, like Arabic, Hebrew. It's very nice. I do like them. Cheers for the follow. There you go. Mark is there. So cheers for the follow, everybody.
Well done, Sandy.
It's all kicking off. It's just Jason, Jarvis, and...
How many listeners have we got at the moment, by the way?
It says here we have 39, which is about what we've had all day. On the YouTube.
That's more than 30, more than I expected, to be honest.
I did say that normally we get maybe between 100 and 150, but most people are going to be want to watching the game. But I reckon this will get a lot of views back afterwards, because the number of views this gets on YouTube afterwards is... Most pods get about 500 or 600, then the radio ones are getting a couple of thousand.
We get a lot of people listening back to old radio shows, don't we? Like games that
200.
Have gone past.
Yeah, 200 a week from a pod radio.
Stoke Away game was very popular for some reason, probably because we were all pissed off. But
I will say, at All in the Past just tweeted at us. Will you be doing things to one another? it's gonna be quite difficult.
I hope not. However,
we're all three in different places.
If somebody wants to offer me a considerable amount of cash, I will get my arse out.
So everyone keep their money where it is.
Only my answer, I'm afraid. I got standards.
I will say also, as Danny's been saying, we've had 39 listeners. If you guys like this, let us know, because we'll do it more.
Yeah,
this is the and first if you one. Fucking hate it,
we might
we'll
even
still
have,
do
tell
it.
Us. We might even have some sort
we
of.
Probably will.
We'll have still some do it. Sort of professionalism next time.
Ooh, it's all getting a little bit egg lance legs.
Look out! Look out!
My cat has come to join me. Hello, Bob.
Seb has just retweeted it. Thank you very much, Seb. Christopher Stola.
Seb became on Bicycle Kicky.
Yeah. Tom Canton. All Jason needs is another Jeff. And that's our lineup for North American Foster style adverts.
Danny, am I right in saying that with Jason joining us, are we back up to a perfect 11 again? I think we are, aren't we?
It's hard to know.
Well, count.
Yeah.
It's not difficult. Fuck's sake.
Well, it's hard to know whether because
well, if you well,
there's some other things going on. We're not sure whether people are actually here, whether FK is on a sabbatical that I'm trying to convince him that he is, or whether he's actually just going to leave like Gav did, and we will love him, and whenever he's available, like FK and Gav are both doing transfer deadline days. So yes. Unlike other places where people leave and they go no, like when someone leaves a radio station, they go no, not talking about it. Yeah. No, FK has been. I think he got promoted at work, and now he's abroad a lot of the time. Like, I think he's just spent a month in
Dubai,
and I know Andy was also in Japan recently. Yeah, and he says, yeah. So FK handed in his resignation. We said, don't go. And he said, I can still do other stuff. So then we snapped Jason up, who was a free agent. He's he's got probably more experience than. When was the first time we did a podcast, Jace?
A
football podcast.
Of any kind?
Yeah.
Was September 2013.
Oh, right, no, he hadn't been doing longer than, because me and Gimli first started doing them in October 2012 and November 2012.
So, I've been in broadcasting since 2008. Well, technically, I've been in broadcasting almost my whole life. I did a lot of TV stuff for the church that I went to back home in Arkansas. I started doing broadcasting stuff when I was 12.
Funny, I can't remember the name of the Tom Hanks film. What was the name of Tom Hanks' film? So, where they filmed him his entire life.
Not Truman Show.
Show.
No, that's Jim
Truman
Carrey.
That's it, yeah. So, you, Jason, you are the Arsenal Truman Show. Who's he booked now?
I don't know. Ramsey, no, Ramsey already bought it. Monreal.
No. Oh, handball.
Handball.
Fernandinho. What the other one?
Fernandinho, yeah.
Yeah, so there you can't.
How do you tell Fernandinho and Fernando apart?
They are very similar, aren't they, in their build and everything?
And I'm not trying to be racist about that, but like from a distance, it's very difficult to tell the two apart.
Yeah,
a little bit like Louis Boamorte and Ian Wright.
Yes.
At the game where they unveiled Louis Boamorte, and all we kept singing was Ian Wright, right, right, and Ian wasn't even at the club.
we need to get our foot in a bit here. We're letting them dictate
the
pace. Not the possession, but we're letting them dictate the pace now. Like here. Yeah. They've got two up front now. Have they gone 4-4-2? Because Jovetic is up with Aguero. Oh! It looks like they've gone 4-4-2.
They are pushing. It's times like this that we need Rosicky in midfield to get him on the counter-attack and maybe get Giroud off, get Walcott on, and their pace. The fact that Theo has so much pace, they'll shit their pants with Rosicky and Theo on.
The higher they push. It's all about timing, though. You don't want to bring them on too early. I would say 60, 65, maybe.
That was Sanchez. Good job, Sanchez. I really think that this is... You're right. We've either got to bring Walcott on to stretch their defense, we need to bring Mesut on in place of Ox to keep the ball. Just so that I love Ox and I love the pace that he brings.
Plus,
he does tend to give it over.
Because at the moment they're only going to have one person on the Ox. You bring Mesut on, they're going to try and put two on Mesut and two on Sanchez.
Santi because all of that.
Go on, Santi, off you go, son.
Yeah, that was really.
Here we go. Ooh,
get it down. Keep the ball now. Just keep the ball. Take the
sting. It's amazing. We've had 55 minutes of football and done about a minute of commentating.
Go on.
Lift! Shoot!
Hit it!
Shoot! Oh. You silly bitch!
Didn't get the right pass. He didn't get the pass in front of him. No, it wasn't Ramsey's fault. The pass wasn't the best.
No,
For once.
Yeah, it was a tough angle. He's got to go near post.
There you go, people.
What is... Oh.
Who's he going to book?
Who's this for? He does look like Jasper Carrot, doesn't he?
Oh, come on.
He's booked him for looking like Andrew. PR, who are you?
Yeah, he has.
Oh, here we go.
Right.
Nico Gunner. Oh. Time for Rosicky to come on for Rambo. I think you're not wrong, sir.
Agree.
Danny, and remind then, me to talk to you. Remind me to talk to you off air about something that I need to talk to you about.
No, I'll forget. You like Jeff, other Jeff was saying last night. Oh, it's time to do this. Put the blog up. Then just press. I kept forgetting to bloody do it.
All right, I'll try.
Did he do that?
I'll try and remember. There's something I wanted to talk to you about. It's nothing major. I just completely forgot until earlier.
Carl, who is says watching the game.
Stand up. Well done.
Carl, who is that_London_guy, I recognise that name, watching the Arsenal game with the AFC podcast
boys. Not there.
Retweet that.
Thank you.
Don't fuck about good challenge. Well done. Nice. Cazorla again. He's done brilliantly in that role, hasn't he? Well done, Alexis.
Seriously. Thank you. Fuck, yeah. Mike Dean finally gives a fucking foul.
That brilliant tackle from Cazorla all came because Ramsey fucked about with it on the edge of the box.
Talking about tackles... After the game, Jace, you're going to have to go through your rant that you give about the fouls that you did in the WhatsApp group, because that I applauded that once I finished listening.
It was impressive.
Yeah.
You're quite an angry young man.
It's I'm about to do it like right now, because that's just...
that's what reminded me.
It's not just... I'll go ahead and do it now for people who are listening, and I'll probably do this again during the show a little later as well once the game is off. The fact that it's not just football, it's not just the Premier League, it's worldwide football. I see it at the second division in the U.S. I see it in baseball in the United States, especially the NFL has been one of the best places actually for refereeing because they are taking decisions, they're taking the quote unquote human element out. But the fact that all these refs, they're getting famous now, and they're they know that if they make the controversial call or that they can influence a game so much, just as much as a player can now. And the issue is the fact that now they're saying, well, if I don't make this call, or if I do make this call, you know, I'll be liked more here, liked more there. And they're trying to become famous. Instead of sticking to the true traditional role of the referee in the game, which is to call a fair and balanced game. Beautiful tackle. Oh, my God.
He's been very good.
That was God, I just came.
Coming of age, that boy. The referee thing, Jace, it's what I like to call Jesus. Uriah Rennie syndrome. Do you remember him? Uriah Rennie?
No, I don't.
Oh, ninja, you're a big black, the only black referee we've had forever.
Yeah, he was a black belt. He became a superstar, didn't he?
It was all about him. Well, I think people
the issue is these guys want to get their...
Just go and watch videos
of
him.
They want to get their name out.
Pierluigi Collini, go and watch videos of him. Refereeing, and then you will learn something. Yep. Best referee ever.
Yeah, and the issue is,
and he was good
because they're becoming famous. They're taking more and more decisions into their hands. The one thing that the NFL has done that I really applaud, and it's not a whole lot that I applaud from them, is the fact that they're taking judgment decisions away from the referee, and they're making them black and white decisions to where you're either right or you're wrong, and if you're wrong, we're going to let you know. And the fact that and Dom said it on the pod, the fact that the EPL and football as a whole in Europe is one of the only institutions that does not have like a video replay tribunal or some sort of...
Christ on a bike. Matt Saka got a really important touch there.
After spood.
Important
touch. Oh my God. Jesus. It's the fact that there's got to be some... Because if you look at... Especially the decisions against... Sorry. That was a motorcycle. Chelney. They got that touch that just knocked it wide. But if you look at the NFL has taken away a little bit of the credibility of the referee, but the referees are okay with that. Because the referees in the NFL eventually want to get the call right instead of become... Just the man themselves. Good job, Ospina. That was difficult as shit, actually.
Take your time.
If we could just
Because you look at the things that the fucking Charlie Adams have done and things like that against in these Stowe games where they've used literal... this isn't an exaggeration. That was a literal fucking wrestling move that he did against Sanchez a couple weeks ago. Like, and how is that not... And then you have Arnautovic coming back and shoving when there was nothing to be gained from a shove other than quote-unquote physical play. On Debuchy, and you see what's happened to him, and yeah, Arnautovic is, you know, he said, "Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to hurt you." Oh God.
There was an excellent interview with I forget the journalist's name, but this week's Ask Blogs on Friday, he had an interview with a journalist from I can't remember what paper it might I don't know whether it was the The Guardian or the who is it? Sorry.
Tommy's coming on.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, you're right. But yeah, he had an interview, and he was talking about how serious these shoves are becoming in sport, about how dangerous they're becoming.
It's a lot in basketball, doesn't it?
It was a really good interview. It's well worth listening if you haven't. It was very, very good. But yeah,
the one thing that has doomed sort of football as a whole, I think, is the whole diving issue.
Hmm.
Is it's become more difficult to tell when someone has dove or when someone's legitimately being pushed.
But after the game, you can find them, can't you? That's what we were saying on the pod.
You can, but that is the issue. You have to have something after the game that is set up to look at everything off the ball. Mm. Almost everything on the ball is going to be called at some point.
Mm.
Off the ball is where you've really got to take a look at these things is a video review or a tribunal or whatever you want to set up and say, listen, this should be punished. Whether the referee fucking saw it or not. Let me tell you, EPL, your refs can be fucking wrong, you pieces of shit. Right? They can be fucking wrong. And the fact that you don't allow them to be wrong makes them even more wrong. Mm-hmm. Admit that they can be wrong and take the judgment decision out of their hand. Let them call black and white and not gray.
Ironically.
And I think that would be really, really... I think you see a lot better officiating, not only in the EPL, but across Europe.
And ironically, we've got a decision that was absolutely right today, which normally I don't think we would have got.
Here comes MLS.
Yeah. 100 times, yeah. Here comes New York City FC's Frank Lampard. Or is it?
You got a very good point there, Jace. The whole thing with the Premier League, with the referees, is that ex-referees referee the current referees, and it's all an old boys club, and it is don't want to do anybody out of it, and there's no competition for it, and it's all who you know, and as long as you go along with it, and it's just too the game when I replied in the WhatsApp group about it. That poor bloke who was playing, I can't remember what game it was, but the ball he was laying on down on the Leicester pitch in the penalty area. The ball hit him in the head. Leicester, only did Liverpool. They give him a penalty, he got sent off. And at no point did the referee go, "Oh, I'm sorry about that." And you can't even talk to the referees until half an hour after the game.
And they all get their story straight, like we said on Thursday as well.
Good catch.
Right,
all the Espina haters can bite me.
Who's Tommy coming on for? Ramsey?
Yes, has to.
It should be, whether it is or not, I'm not sure.
Oh, done company.
You're not really going to argue with company, are you? You're going to end up in hospital.
I would. Smash him in the face.
Let him know you're there.
Squeeze his big head spot. Oh, no, that's his head. Sorry.
Lily.
Lily, that tickles. Yeah, tickles, Lily. My cat's watching.
I mean, and to me, honestly, the biggest thing is the suspension with Giroud. He should have been suspended for a game. For getting up in the face aggressively of another player and making contact. You should not make contact with another player's head.
I'm not sure he did.
In an intentional way. Was that a true fucking headbutt? Did he rear his head back?
Of course it wasn't. Of course it wasn't.
Trying to butt? No, it wasn't a fucking real headbutt.
Because it would
have
hurt.
Get the fuck out 3 games. Mm. Oh my God. Like, get out. Like, they went face to face, nose to nose, as you would with any man in real life who fucking did that to you.
Lily. Sorry.
So that was my big issue with that, was it should have been a 3-game ban. Mm. Giroud should have been smart enough not to know to make contact with the player.
Don't fuck about with it.
Ooh.
But
straight back up.
Come on. Good job.
Eat heel like
go.
Give it.
Just fucking get it out of the middle of the fucking park.
No, that's fine. That's fine. Now travel.
Go,
now
travel.
In FIFA, I'd have scored from that. I'd have first tried.
Really, how many times is he going to do that?
And so is he not even booking it?
Ox has got to move into the space. There was space in behind, and he had his man beat.
Oxlade-Chamberlain's coming off.
Yep.
Jarvis thinks we're funny as fuck, but he asterisked it. Bless you, Jarvis. Casey called and said, absolutely brilliant, brilliant entertainment. Jarvis says, fuck yeah. Antoine, oh, he's finally joined us. We'll do a show after, take a 45-minute break and come back for an hour. No, we'll just talk about the game straight away after, because none of us have anything to do.
Speak for yourself.
You don't.
Go do.
Brush your hair.
You did everything yesterday, Kris. Remember, you hollowed out that place so that you could place your one suit.
Oh, by the way, Akib's tweeted and said it was the Independent. It was Glenn Moore who gave that interview. Okay. Thank you, Akib. Cheers, mate. Okay.
Go on. Oh, please, go on.
You son!
Bastards!
Oh, I just got the shit out of my cat, and I don't care. Get in!
Where's Jarvis? He's one of your own, Jarvis. I think your friend.
Beautiful.
Massive goal, that is. Massive. Hit him in the nose.
I would drink his bath water after that.
Oh, no, it's all red. Yes.
He didn't even try reaching for it, you lazy, bouffanted twat.
Because he's shit. I told you this. I've been telling you this for years.
That's why he's
so I'm not going to lie. Joe Hart reminds me. I have no idea why he does. I have no reasoning behind it. Joe Hart reminds me of a younger Jeremy Clarkson.
Yeah, he does. He really does. Just give us
I have nothing to back it up, but he just reminds me of a younger Jeremy Clarkson. Like, he's
gonna... Curse against or over, question mark.
Who? What, where?
Jarvis. Curse against top four over.
No. Let's get to the end of the game first, shall we?
And it says, "Mais we." That's only something. Yes.
I will say.
I've seen us fuck up.
Oh, look at that! He's laying on the back and he still clears it. Oh,
What we need to do now is
the boss.
We need to keep this tight now for 10-15 minutes. Because if we concede straight after scoring, we'll be right on the back foot again.
It would be just like us to concede at this point in the game as well. Just going up.
They will be looking for a penalty too.
Away.
Yeah. Oh, look at that! Monty's fucking coming on, isn't he? He's having a hell of a
brilliantly. Nice. Said for ages, all these people slagging him off. He's a bloody good defender.
No, £8.5 million is not it. Or £7.5 million.
I did send to Cage that my prediction for the game was 2-1 with Santi as the first goal scorer. So I almost want him to score, but at the same time I don't.
Broken the internet. Away. Stand up.
I think Danny should recreate the Kim Kardashian.
Don't even joke about these things.
There's not enough oil.
Oh, God.
I've got a lovely arse, apparently.
Oh, for fuck's sake. I'm sorry, people. I'm really sorry about this.
If we would have hit live earlier, you people would have seen a great shot of Kris almost showing his ass.
Yeah, I was scratching
it. I quickly called him out for.
Sometimes you need to scratch your bum.
I love Kris, but not that much.
Mark Tag says he's only been listening since half time, but enjoying the YouTube thing.
Oh, the Taggy. Isn't Ian Oz as well? Is it Oz he's in? Where is Taggy?
Yeah, no, that's the one I'm just saying. It's he's a new one. It's Aussie Gooner 80. That's Mark Tag.
Oh, sorry, that is Mark Tag. Yeah, sorry, sorry, my bad. Yeah, sorry, yeah.
Thank you, Mark. We appreciate it.
Yeah, Mark's a good guy. I like Mark.
I will say whether the listeners like it or not, I'm having a fucking blast on here.
Yeah.
This is almost as good as watching like a Manchester United game with 90 other goobers at Bull McCabe's here in the triangle. So I'm having a fucking blast. And the reason I didn't go today is because in North Carolina you can't buy alcohol on Sunday until noon. Because we're in the quote unquote Bible Belt.
Oh,
I stayed home so I could drink earlier.
Ouch.
I thought you were near Miami.
No.
Where'd you get that from?
No. I don't know. I've not checked out where Carolina is. Oh, South Carolina. That's all near. Yeah, I know where that is.
It's Hardy Boys country.
But I'm in North Carolina.
Yeah, no, I've heard of South Carolina.
Yeah.
And my geography's not bad. I just hadn't really thought about it. Why did I think you were near Miami?
No idea. Fresno's not far from Miami. Maybe that's where you got confused.
No, Fresno is terribly far from Miami.
Oh, is it? Oh, no, it's California, isn't it? Sorry.
Yeah,
ignore me.
Yeah.
Oh, Fresno, that's America is all the fucking same. Everything's close to everything else.
They just get a load of English names, but
new tiny, tiny country, that America. Really small.
New, like New York.
I didn't know that Australia used to be called New Holland or New something like that. I sort of put a picture of it to Dom. I was watching a film called Predestination.
Dom said close enough, didn't he?
Yeah, Predestination, and there was it was set. The first part of it must have been set in the 1940s, and the map of Australia had the bottom left-hand corner missing because they hadn't invented it yet.
They hadn't found it. Invented it.
I just hate people. When was America invented? Actually, I heard a term
1987.
I'm going to get to my nervous pacing stage soon. I'll have to stand up.
I can't. I don't know if I can sit down anymore. And the issue is, I couldn't find my longer cord.
That's what she said.
Gentle German Gooner says to me, "You look like a nice, lovable uncle to me. You probably aren't."
No, he's not.
No, my brother hasn't procreated yet.
Go on, Santi.
I'm trying to get him a prostitute, but he's not interested.
Go on, Santi.
Nice, good ball.
Benjamin Lockwood has just retweeted the thing. And so has ADT Getty Bay. That's just a number of fucking all letters and numbers mixed up. I've got no idea what that says.
Hit it. Get in. Oh, suck a ball.
Chip, put it there. Chip it over.
Irrational noises.
Let's have a look at the stats. Where are we up to? Oh, pass success rate 84.75. Oh, that can't be right. Let's fucking refresh that page.
I knew somebody would say it.
We've only still got 35% possession.
Akiv just tweeted, he said, if you decide to do this every week, we might actually win every game. I knew somebody would say something.
We've started it,
so we'll finish.
Jarvis says, from Opta, Arsenal have now scored 9 headed goals.
Oh, good.
But Adam's got done off
season. Only West Ham with 14 have more.
There you go.
Yankee Gunner just put, Santi's feet are made of magic.
Magic feet.
Two-footed, love him. Time is slowly ticking. Slowly, slowly, slowly.
Oh, Nico Gunner is in Denmark. Mm-hmm. He says, in Denmark we have Jan Molby. He's a Danish man with a Scouse accent. It's crazy.
TV channel, yeah.
Has commentary today, so put the game on mute and I listen to you guys instead. Thanks.
We're more insightful. Oh, hey, my favourite Norwegian-American has moved back to the MLS this week.
Who is that?
Mix Diskerud, yeah.
Dix Miskerud?
Yeah, he's actually gone to what are they called, isn't he? Bollocks. Orlando.
I will say the great thing is our club, our development team, our U-23, had 3 players drafted this in the MLS draft this week.
Mm-hmm.
We had one attacker, a defender, and then a midfielder. And a guy that you really want to watch out for in MLS is a guy named Connor Donovan. Ended up going to Orlando City as well.
Mm.
Great, great defender, good in the air. Scored against Mexican team Puebla from the Mexican First Division when we played them in an exhibition last year. Yeah, Connor Donovan, great, great kid.
Any relations to the Donovan?
No. No relation to the Donovan.
Are they in the MLS then, Orlando, this year?
Yeah, first
they
season.
They are. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this will be their first year.
I love Mix because he's got a cool name and he's got lovely hair. So.
Oh, sexy Mixy Diskerud.
He's a good little player as well, very good little player.
I'll tell you who has been the most underrated U.S. player has probably been Kyle Beckerman.
Oh, Beckerman's quality.
Oh, he's a star.
The dreadlock
man.
If he had pace, he would have been wanted in Europe.
Yeah.
If
yeah, that's his one. That's the one area that he lacks. Good job.
Well done.
Good job.
All of that defense has been brilliant, haven't they? Really.
Someone Jarvis views on Ospina so far. Fucking
fine.
Brilliant.
Yeah, absolutely fine.
Really, yeah,
as we said on Thursday, it's nice to have a goalkeeper that actually just stands in his goal.
Keeps.
Yeah, it just does what you ask him to do.
Doesn't play rush goalkeeper.
Right, they're going to go 3 up front now. So this is for me.
What is it?
This is when we bring Walcott on now.
But who does? So who does he come in for though?
Shiri.
I'm talking about Jekko. So who does Jekko come in for? Is he going to come in?
They'll take off. No, they'll take off the other holder. They'll take off Fernandinho.
That's what I said. Defensive midfielders.
Really? Yeah.
And they'll go three up. Well, Santi again.
Oh,
Santi
look at
again.
You cannot stop me.
Oh, yes. Wonderful. I love the feral cat
of the Emirates.
Fairmont wonders what time we're on. We're on 75, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44. Just pause your telly. We're all on the same time, roughly.
Oh, Santi makes my panties wet.
Carlos Burke, quietest feet ever.
He's just a gem of a footballer.
Navas came off.
Navas, that does surprise
dirty
me.
Dirty Viking. Yeah.
Although they can play Jovetic wide now. They put Jovetic wide.
Yeah. That's why I wanted Jovetic earlier on when he came from Florida. I wanted him at Arsenal because of his versatility.
Play wide. Yeah.
You can move him out wide, let him cut inside, or you can play him and he'll run this champ.
They'll put three up front now, won't they? They'll put Jekko at the head, Aguero and Jovetic
balls,
behind.
Deep crosses.
Yeah,
long balls.
Fat Frank's got the ball. He smelled donuts. He's off.
long balls, something that you specialise in, Danny, there.
Hey.
I get Theo balls. Because they are going to push everything forwards now. If there was ever a time to put Theo on, it would be
on
now.
On the break, they will shit their pants.
We need to keep
another clear. Sanchez clearing.
Only beer two of the second half, by the way.
It was the cock clearing.
And so. anyone that questioned whether Coquelin could do it in a big game, he's answered those questions, hasn't he?
But do you think Coquelin will go, you've treated me so disrespectfully, yes. Three loans out, I'm not staying when my contract is up.
No,
I'm going to play my arse off and then I'm off.
No, because he's in the team. He's getting games now. That's all.
His contract must be up soon.
We're talking to him, aren't we? Apparently going to give him a new deal. That was it. Came out last night.
With the way he's playing now, we need to.
Yeah, don't get me wrong. We still need another. You know, it's not always like a new signing. We still need someone else. But I would definitely. Exactly. I'd rather keep him than give Flamini a longer deal.
Are you not going to fucking book fat fuck God. For that? You fucking fat
but
fucky fuck.
For the record, I agreed with Dom the other night.
I think
Arteta has been given a new 1-year deal. I think he will be if he hasn't. But I reckon he has already.
That's fucking better.
And I would actually give Flamini another 1-year deal, but I would have him as backup.
Squad player.
Yeah, both have him as backup. I wouldn't get rid of him, but I would have a new, brand new central midfielder as our starter. I'd have Coquelin as his backup, and then I'd have Flamini in our
third. We're playing four competitions a year, aren't we?
Exactly. You need players.
But do you think Coquelin actually, with the performance he's putting in, do you think Coquelin's going to be happy being a substitute for Schneiderlin?
No, I'd keep him in. I'd keep
I don't think Schneiderlin's coming.
I'm talking about the summer. I would buy somebody in midfield now to do a job.
Yeah.
And then have him as backup.
No, don't.
But then
in the
summer, we go big, and then we say to Coquelin, look, we're buying another central midfielder, but if you keep playing as you are, you're staying inside. Yeah. Competition for players.
Yeah, but the issue is if you don't have games, it's so hard for you to keep your form.
Yeah, but then equally, if you don't have anyone pressuring you, Chesney, then you get complacent and you wonder why you're outside.
But not everybody's as douchey as Chesney is. I mean, let's admit that. Like he is
an arrogant fuck, it looks like.
He's a petulant child.
Rosicky couldn't even get on the bench at the start of the season. Yeah. Now he's one of our first starters.
He's one of the Czech Republic's greatest ever players.
Mm.
And he just did his job like a pro.
I just don't know if we could actually get Coquelin to continue to stay as in a backup role. I think he would move to a smaller team.
Oh yeah, you don't tell him he's going to pick up, but you tell him what he wants to hear.
I don't think Wenger will say to someone you're guaranteed to play every game. He just said
Nobody should be guaranteed to play.
Apart from Sanchez.
Anyone.
Cause
we all know Sanchez will play every game, but no one should be guaranteed.
Wonderful.
Offside.
Still misses.
Oh, no.
You have them all day long.
Caught up.
Fuck, I'm going to have to stand up. I can't stay. I can't stay seated.
What if Steve comes and tells you to sit down, Jace? You're going to hit him.
I can't stay seated.
10 minutes. Massive 10 minutes. Especially with the results yesterday. Away!
Nice. Oh, look at that. Safe hands.
Just catches the ball. Lays on it, takes his time.
Not around with it either. None of that wild fucking.
He does look like a bouncer off a club, doesn't he?
He does look like he knows where the cakes
are. He could work China Whites on a Saturday night easily.
What we've got in the window.
If your name's not Dan, fuck off.
Giroud must play for Set Police, says Antoine. Mm-hmm. Can't you see it? Carl says, can't you see it? Like a new signing.
That is the line. But then, you know what? Everyone's saying about this in this window. All we really need in this window is a centre-back. You know, I don't think we should go and buy a midfielder. Unless the right one comes up now, then we shouldn't be going for one anyway.
Go on, Thomas!
Thomas?
Antoine says that Flamini has got an option on a third year that the club can exercise if they want.
Yeah, so give him that one year. Go on, Pellerin.
Zach Buddy says, I think Monreal deserves huge credit for this season, one of our players of the season this year. I think he's definitely come into form the last month, 6 weeks.
By the way, Flamini's not a terrible footballer. He hasn't had the best season, but he's a good squad player.
He hasn't got the tools to be a
He's not going to get another big move, so you might as well keep him around.
Against the Palaces, against the Burnleys,
you can rotate him.
You can.
Yeah, I agree.
Look, Ramsey is just like he's breathing out of his ass. Look.
Of course he is.
He needs to come off. Get Ozil on.
No.
Fuck!
Ozil's too dainty. Well, not dainty, but this isn't the game for Ozil.
No.
If anything, I'd get Callum Chambers on and put him in that midfield role alongside Coquelin and just
go and hit Fat Frank.
Yeah, go and hit him.
What you do, you get Callum Chambers, you cover him in honey and sugar, and then just get Lampard to chase him around the pitch for the last 10 minutes.
Yeah, Ramsey's dead, look.
He's dead. He's died.
Dead.
Gone.
Died.
Carl Ward.
That looks like me after 10 minutes.
Looks like me after 3. Looks like me getting out of bed. I get out of bed, I'm like, fucking hell.
No shit. My first ever full, 11v11 soccer match. And I
14 corners.
I felt like I'd been in for almost an hour.
Punching bag.
And I came in at the 10-minute mark. It was like a free substituting game. Felt like I'd been out. I was like, it's got to be halftime now.
Blowing hard.
I played for 35 minutes. I asked the linesman, I said, what's the time? He said, 25 minutes. I had been in for 15 minutes and was fucking dead.
Did you hear that shout from Ospina there, by the way?
Kieran Gibbs. Leave it. Oh, here we go, Flame and...
Do you know what? I forgot Flamini was on the bench, to be honest.
We're bringing a policeman on. We're going to bring on a policeman and a steward to hit someone.
No. So, okay, here's the thing. Last year, when we went on our great run of games, we had Monreal and Gibbs finishing out each game, if you remember.
Yeah, we did.
I really hope that he's not taking Monreal off. I hope that he's bringing Gibbs on to play on that left-hand side.
Please score.
Not shooting there, Thomas.
Actually, Vikas RK says he's losing his accumulator because Arsenal had Arsenal to draw. He's going to lose 480 quid. And he says he's still happy because we're winning.
Yeah, I was going to say, fuck the accumulator. Well done, Alexis.
Hold on, we're doing a defensive substitution because we want to hold the lead. Yeah. We're going to be fucking possessed.
That's absolutely fine at this stage.
Yeah, it is.
Our loyal travel support there.
We are bringing on 2 defensive players to hold a lead. I never thought I'd see the fucking day.
No.
So I'm not going to lie, there is no more tense moment for me in my life than the last minutes of an Arsenal game.
Well done. It's done a good job.
My butthole wasn't crunched this much when I was walking through a minefield in Afghanistan.
Are you in your Sunday night strolls looking for ice cream?
If you've ever had Afghani ice cream, it's fucking delicious.
I bet they make it properly.
Dwayne on Twitter just said, since his son got his Arsenal kit at the end of November, we haven't lost a game since, so maybe it's all down to him.
Grabbing at straws.
Mark said he agrees with me to get Chambers on, but that ship has sailed now. But
I would pay Flamini just to go and hit Lampard.
I did forget we had the Flame on the bench. Come on, boys.
How many players are the Man City players have got their hands down by their sides like they've given up?
Don't curse it.
There's no cursing.
Yeah, there is. Away! Away!
Go on, Thomas! Off we go!
The yellow arrows.
He's off to the corner.
Go on, Gibbo.
Remember, Gibbo used to be a striker. He's got pace.
Challenge.
Oh, I think someone
that was that was a Chris Carpenter-esque tackle. Nice. That was.
Or was that the Ox? I can't tell.
Keep it.
He's given a foul.
No.
I thought that was a good tackle. Always booked Aguero because he tried to foul on the break.
Yeah.
I took Aguero out of my
dream team. Look at that. Look at that.
Pull the shirt. Fucking hell. He kept him off the TV.
Don't run away.
That's the one good thing about these super tight-ass Puma shirts is you know when someone's pulling our shirt.
Oh, yeah. You can't get away with it.
I am so pleased that we are playing so defensive at this point.
Well,
normally, so many times Wenger has made stupid substitutions and brought on 7 strikers for a goalkeeper when we're winning, then we end up losing.
7 strikers for a goalkeeper.
Oh, go on, little twinkle. The man with the quietest feet in football.
I'm not going to lie. If we score here, I'm going to pee myself.
Tippy-tappy.
These little size 2s.
Oh, and then he does that. Bless him. Well, bear with me a second. I'm just going to turn my heating off. 2 seconds.
Are you calling me? Bubba? Did you call me?
Sorry, I was burning alive.
Danny, I'm eating that match program rolled up about right now, by the way.
You what?
I'm eating that match program rolled up right now, by the way.
Like in the old days.
In the standing section.
Can someone go and stand in front of him? He's got big pockets and he's a piss.
Please.
Come on, 4 minutes, 3 minutes. Well, 4 minutes plus
this,
10 minutes stoppage
this means
time.
The Arsenal Twitter's view is going to be a happy place to be.
Oh, don't know. Someone will find something. Somebody will find a negative.
We've got rid of Sanogo for. Oh, look at that. Beautiful man.
Beautiful.
Look at him. He doesn't care. It's cold. He's got extra pants on.
He don't care. He's hard as nails.
And it just think how much you and me can go on about just how good we told you Ospina would be. We
said
it all the way from the World Cup.
Looks like Sylvester Stallone's stunt double.
He's doing a new Rambo, isn't he?
God, is he really?
God, oh, look, really is a good ball.
Let or just shoot.
Go on, Santi.
Left.
Go on, Gibbo. Oh, that's terrible, Gibbs. That's terrible.
Isn't that? It's wasted time.
Why didn't he corner flag that? I'd have corner flagged that.
Yeah.
3 minutes to go. Not complaining, but just saying.
Oh, Clarkson ruined
Gary Neville just said the same thing.
Zach Buddy is put, has anyone seen Aguero today? And Jarvis is put in
Koscielny's pocket. Yeah, exactly. Just goes to show, though, we can defend.
Can. Bit of confidence.
We can defend.
Look at them. We're still giving them. How furious would we be now? 2-0 down at home and we're giving the ball away. Look, 22. Clichy didn't even fucking move to stop that ball.
Mark's just said on Twitter as well, he said, if Wenger goes out and buys a defender after the tactics today, I'm scared that the end of the world is coming. He's right. He's absolutely right. Stand him up. Send him out. Send him wide. Don't jump in. What a Mertesacker.
Oh.
That's it. Sorry. Twat the ball away. Wasted.
Delayed him just enough.
No, it's fine.
I will kill you. I have a certain set of skills that involve defending.
As long as the milk doesn't sour, we're all good.
Wait.
Nice. Oh, you useless egg-headed twat.
I genuinely thought that looped in for a minute.
His head was too big to put it on target.
He's Man City's Pascal Seguin.
Oh, you're not.
I forgot he's actually playing. He scored the other night, didn't he, in the French League Cup?
Yeah, he did, for Bastia, yeah.
He's 34.
Yeah, he's still shit.
Ospina.
Still seems weird. I watched the Inter game yesterday, and it still seems weird, like, seeing Silvino as Mancini's assistant.
Silvino?
Yeah, he's in.
Well, one.
Yeah, he's assistant manager at Inter now.
Oh, I did wonder where the boy had got to.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
great ball. Ball. Go on,
Flamini.
Yes, cross it.
That's fine. We got a call.
Why
we can waste some time.
That far forward?
What happened there?
The world is he does Clichy on toast.
Yeah. Oh.
Boom.
Boom.
He nearly did the goal.
Sit down, bitch.
4 minutes. Oh, there's the lesbian. Look, that's the lesbian.
Fat faced lesbian. Oh, look at that. He's got all FIFA on their asses. Drag back, woo! Side moves. Oh, it's a fucking dream. Woo! I nearly went up Tesco's on, what was it, Friday?
What, do you want a medal?
PS4. All right. You're gonna go I thought I might go and buy one, but now you're going to shop it.
Why don't you get it home delivered?
Because there's no offers on at the moment. There's no double bonus points.
Yeah,
there's no offers on, and I'm not paying £300 for one.
No, I'm just saying, get it delivered from Tesco's, and you don't have to go out to get it.
No, I thought I'd go and have a look. Find out myself to one, stick one in my pocket.
In your pocket and walk out. Stick it under your chair, and nobody will know.
It. Drag it behind. They'll think I'm just off on one.
Just pretend you're insane, it works for everyone.
Draw a smiley face in it and tell it it's my baby. Just leave it. Get on with it.
Oh, dear.
We're in the red zone of time.
We are. The famous red zone.
Who fit?
Good job.
Oh,
good
look
job,
at that.
Oh, fucking A, right? That's how you fucking defend.
Why?
Oh,
he's cuddled him.
Pull it.
Is that a cuddle? Is that a cuddle slam dunk? Is that a wrestling move?
I think that was actually technically a Boldo bomb, I think that was.
Do you notice when Ramsey came off, he did not have a hair out of place?
Of course he doesn't. He's beautiful.
Hair. Beautiful. Giroud's hair has been lacking.
The Exorcist 3.
Look at that.
Death stare.
Beautiful Ramsey flow that I've got going on here.
Pellegrini is looking more and more like the Emperor from Star Wars by the day, isn't he?
Antoine says, Fernando with a tackle I'd be proud of in rugby.
Yes, absolutely. Corner flag.
Well, I'm going for the third, just corner to embarrass
flag.
Him.
I'm going for the third.
Flag.
We need the goal diff anyway.
Corner flag. He bent him over and he's fucked him without any lube or warning there. He slapped the old sandpaper condom on and he's gone in deep.
You've gone a little bit off the rocker there, I think.
I've gone all Davis.
The funny thing is, Cliche goes, there's such a thing as lube.
What? I never knew this.
I think you're on your own there.
I don't have to be dry fucked by Vincent anymore.
Vincent.
Oh, he's easy, Tigers. One of you's drunk and one of you's a prostitute.
Oh, he.
How did you know?
We'll leave it to the guests to figure out.
Free kick. Ah, fuck you, Ben Silva. You little rat man.
Yeah, you fuck off, Silva. He's a shit fucking ass.
He can't even spell Silva properly, can he? It's not got an A on the end.
No. Oh, this it could not have gone any better, could it? Clean sheet, winning away.
Not drunk, slightly buzzed.
Drop it in your net, Joe. Boo.
Look at the empty seats, look at that.
Yeah.
All the people
who
thought it was Halloween.
You got no
fame. All the people who thought it was Halloween and dressed as an Etihad seat. Sweet cunt. Halloween's in October.
Keep the ball now, Jess. There you go. Oh, flicks and tricks. Taking the piss out of him now. Well.
Passing it to us. Go on, Lecoq. Oh, lovely. Oh, Bellerin, you wonderful man.
We can now wear yellow every week. I'm fine with it.
Even at home.
I've changed my mind.
I wondered why you were complaining before.
Oh, I just thought it looked silly.
Carl says, best performance of the season.
Yeah, 100%.
Right up there.
And also, it proves we can play under pressure because we could not afford to lose this game.
Here's the issue. It's two good performances consecutive
weeks.
Yes. Well done, ladies.
All right, I'm going to go drain the lizard.
Go and strain the tea.
See if I've had any messages and congratulations from anyone I know. No, just a message from Tesco's.
About your PlayStation.
I'm not feeding you, Dora. You're too fat. You know you're fat. Now leave it.
Well, that couldn't have been any better, could it? Clean sheet, away from home, winning against the odds. What else? Yellow. I'm going to come back now. Oh, nice gratuitous crotch shot there. Let's see if I can work this out. Hello. Thierry Henry, that's what it was.
So it could be one of a million different things.
I put it down to us winning the game. That's what I think it was.
Might help.
Oh, happy days. Massive.
Someone's put a picture of Mikhail Silvestri and said he looks like company. He's got his Teflon head.
Teflon head. Do you want to stick another tweet out to let people know we're doing a post?
Yes.
77 notifications. Fucking hell.
Get this, post it there.
Well, Donkey Kong Schlong. Na 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 na. Oh, I can come off of live pause now, can't I?
Oh yeah.
They look united there as well, don't they? They look like a united squad.
It's weird how these things change.
Alright, where's Ty? Oh god, that was fucking Claude. Oh.
Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, there's Ty. Hello.
Might have known one of the fuckers.
Well, there's Bully. Hot pirate himself. All begging for kit that they can chuck on
sell
eBay.
On eBay.
And
yeah, exactly.
Sell for crack.
Oh, I love that reaction from Murtasaka there. Do you see that? Two fists clenched and a big scream. Yes.
You see, that's what it means to him.
Yeah.
Go and pick Santi up and throw him.
Throw him in the crowd.
Bring him around by his little legs. By his little quiet feet.
Some sort of weird hand signal. Santi looks knackered. I love that boy. I love that boy. I would just... I'd pay to watch him tap dance. West Ham winning again.
I know. Hull
were fucking terrible. Did you see any of that
Hull
game?
Worse. There were things that are terrible in life that would find that offensive being related to Hull. I'm just going to look on rewinding and looking at all the celebration again. All the way back.
All the way back. Watch out for Mertesacker's little fist clench.
I think at one point, Giroud puts his hand on his nose and, you know, where you go, nah, 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 does one of those.
Oh. He can do every once.
Yeah. Here he goes. There you go. He's just done it. Oh, no, he didn't. He was clearing his nostrils.
So we're back to fifth
and then he's
now.
Shaking hands with people. Brilliant.
Who we got next week, Danny?
Brighton. FA Cup.
After that.
I know the... don't know, but then the game after that is Spurs.
Oh, biggie. Can't you see? Home to Villa. Well, that's 3 points. They can't even score, let alone win. Huh? Yeah, home to Villa, away to Scum, home to Leicester, away at Palace, home to Everton, away at QPR, home to West Ham, away at Newcastle, home to Liverpool. There's a lot of winnable games in there, aren't there? Then again, if we play like that, any game's winnable.
People are watching this, they think we should be doing something other than just looking at the telly.
Just talking bollocks.
Okay, so I have to take my dog out, so I'll be back in about 5, but if they want to stay on, please, we will continue to talk about this, correct?
Yeah, we'll still be here.
Me and Daniel
continue the show. Yeah, so I shall return.
Good.
But I will... I don't want the dog to shit in the house, so...
That's very overrated.
That's fair. I would say that is fair.
All right.
Look at all those mugs. Oh, look, Bully, look. He's leaning forward, naked, begging for Giroud's shirt.
He is. Cocking his hand.
You dirty... have a wash.
licking the residual sperm off the players' jerseys.
Oh, that's steady. You've gone there again.
Well... someone had to say it.
The right at the front. Oh, I told you about the bloke in the section I used to sit in every fucking season. He'd get stuff for free. So he'd be at the front begging. And I'd be right at the very back. I'd never move. I'd be sitting there going, yeah, I don't care. I don't need stuff.
I don't need cat.
Wear your shitty second-hand kit.
God bless you. Ah, dear. Well...
it's like they're chucking food to the starving, you scaffy little tits.
Have you seen that picture that French John's just retweeted? It's a picture of Giroud sliding and then the picture of Arsene Wenger on the beach in the slide pose. That's fucking brilliant. I love that. I'm going to retweet that. That's quality.
John has skills.
Santi, man of the match. Easy decision, says Raj.
Yeah.
Yeah, not far away, I would say. That's a pretty good shout.
Hold on, let me think.
Montreal was good. Bellerin was good.
Actually, I'd think Montreal maybe.
Montreal's very good. Montreal's been getting better and better every week.
Hello. Still got a shitty ass. Yep.
Oh, thought you were talking to the cat then.
She's been shitting out of every orifice.
Mm.
Yeah, look, we're still live on YouTube. If I lean forward a bit, you stick your head around, people might see you.
Oh, in fact, French John has just said...
there she is!
French John actually said that Monreal man of the match as well. Yeah, I think he's close. I think because all are just for his overall influence. Coquelin was very good as well. Let's not forget the cock.
The child does not want to be seen.
That didn't work.
Didn't it?
No. you put the camera like halfway across the screen like that instead of like that.
Question for you. Surely Monreal's performance over the last few months has made him his number one choice at left back.
Oh, there's some twat in the chat group called Dom Nusky. Who's that twat?
There's not.
Yeah, there is. Yeah.
Not the Dom.
I doubt whether there's more than one, to be fair.
Does he want to come on and join us?
I don't know. Ask him. He's there. Dom.
Cobba.
Cobba. Fucking hell, Dom.
Mike. Cobba.
Although, saying that, we are like 20 seconds behind, aren't we? So we won't have heard anything we've just said yet. So.
No, so I'm also going to check the WhatsApp group.
Give it 2 minutes and then he'll probably pop back up again. Pop back up. Pop up. Pop up, pop up.
What? I need to boil the kettle. You can boil it.
I just remembered I'm doing
cats
another
thing. Need food. You are?
Yeah, I forgot about that. Me and Gimli are doing Arsenal with my blood again.
Oh, sorry.
You forgot about that.
You've gone all Amanda on us.
No, it was just weird that I've done three in the same week. It's very unusual.
People will get sick of you.
People are sick of me already. It'll be fine. Dom's just put 5,000 messages, mongs. Oh dear. It's like he's never been away.
I think some more organised people would say, we're going to have a break now, we'll be back in half an hour. But I'm not.
Danny, as in Daniel... Clock End Danny said, can you start again so we don't have to watch the whole game on catch up?
why do the transfer deadline day on Sky Sports, are they all wearing yellow? I find that colour irritates me immensely, my
just
eyes.
The bellends. Dom said, nice glasses, four eyes.
It's only so I can see the telly from this far away. I say this far away, I'm about that far away from the telly. No, about that. But in HD, I couldn't see the names on the back of the shirts.
We need to say, what we'll do is we'll timestamp when the radio show starts.
Timestamp? What are you on about? You're just making stuff up.
No, because what Daniel is saying is that if he can't get on live now, and he wants to listen back later on, he won't know what time in this broadcast, the radio period, i.e. the after-game stuff, starts.
That's what he's telling them, that it starts so we need to,
yeah, in the description.
2 hours and 10 minutes in.
Yeah, in the description you need to put what time the radio starts so people can skip to it.
Connor Burke makes a good point. Wenger finally listening to the criticism and changing tactics away to the big sides is the greatest thing he's done in years. It's nice to see us play that way today. It is bloody good. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the breaking news colour, Ant. That's it. I fucking hate it. And the yellow tie. Bullshit. Gold. No need for it.
Ah, John Welsh is in the chat room. Hello, John. He of the beard.
Joe Molman says hello, or says hi. I'll say hello. Daniel McDonald says, don't need to buy a DM. The cock will carry us to glory.
Mm.
Old Tidy Bollocks is on telly. See what he's got to say.
I'm recording it. Jace is back.
It looks like he's got makeup on. Have you got makeup on, Ramsey?
Maybe he does. To be honest, he could wear a fucking fluorescent hat and stockings and suspenders after today. I wouldn't give a monkey's.
Can't have too much of this going out at the same time because we might get pulled.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, Santi.
Just record it and watch it back later, like I'm doing.
I can't do that.
You can't do that.
I can't watch. It's bad enough. I'm watching the post-match stuff as it is, and I'm rewinding it, watching it later.
No, just the interviews. You don't know. Record the. Oh, never mind.
I've no interest in what they have to say normally.
Well, why are you watching it then, you mong?
I said normally. You making me a hot chocolate offspring?
Put a spider in it.
Have fun. Gravy? Why? Oh, have I got anything? Oh, no. Yeah, I'll have marshmallows, no spiders. Easy on the spiders.
Put one in. Put one in.
What other games have we got?
I just want to say, I predicted 2-1 with Santi as the first goal scorer.
Which means you get 1 point.
What do I win?
Nothing. You get 1 point. Because I predicted 2-1 Koscielny first scorer at the start of the season for the Palace game, and they all slagged me off because Cazorla wasn't the first scorer in the game. He was just the first scorer for Arsenal, so everyone banged on about it. And I moaned and said, surely I should get some extra points, and everyone went, nah, 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 nah. And they all let it go.
Well, the issue was Santi was the first scorer of the game, and I called it, because I knew the company was going to give away the penalty, because I'm fucking clairvoyant.
Exactly. You get points for that. You get a point for that.
Thank you.
Mm, you're welcome.
Cologne v Fluminense.
Sixth beer of the day, by the way.
Sixth. Best
beer of the day.
Right.
I'm going to watch.
And the Guinness hasn't even arrived.
Jesus.
Danny, when do you want us to go radio live? When?
Can do now, I think.
Okay, well, go now then.
5 minutes. I'm just seeing what I'm going to watch. A bit of Deportivo Barcelona.
I'm watching that.
Then I'm
going to
go and watch a little bit of African Cup of Nations, which is going to be what game is it? It's going to be Tunisia v Cape Verde.
Sounds like
it's
hell.
An interesting one this year because Nigeria haven't qualified.
No.
Because they lost to South Africa.
I hope South Africa win it. I'm not going to watch any of it though. I can't be bothered. Too much European football to watch.
Of it.
Right. So can you make a note of the timestamp as to when the radio starts?
5 minutes post match. There you go.
You guys know that we are still live. Right?
Yeah, yeah.
Everybody
can
still see us.
More organized people would.
Danny, make sure you write that down.
Back on air.
Chat box is going to go up, and you'll miss that message otherwise.
I'm going to go and tweet it.
Okay.
General. People go, what the fuck?
Because otherwise people might not want to listen to us talk bollocks for 90 minutes.
The other good news is that my wife is home with our groceries, which means Guinness is now here.
By the time we go off air, he's going to be three sheets to the wind.
Cock and Danny, give him a follow. He just tweeted.
I won't even go off air. I'm just going to pass out on my computer.
Face down on the keyboard.
Sunny V Jetfire. Oh, there you go, Sunny. Give your son Sunny. Sunjay.
Oh, that's the best tweet ever. I'm going to retweet that as well.
So long since we beat a big team. Don't know what to do. Looking forward to more positive podcasts and Ask Blog Pods in the next week. That deserves a retweet.
Have you seen that tweet from William Conception? He's tagged in me, Jeff, and Jason, and it's basically a picture with a dog with his head out the window with sunglasses on and a scarf around his neck. It says, beating City at their house, my kind of weekend. That's awesome. I've retweeted that. That's quality.
Oh, Dwayne Isaac is off. He'll have to spend more time with his missus.
Peg Gunner, I love you all up the Arsenal crisis. Love. There's love in the Arsenal community. The world is going to end.
Has anybody seen the Vine of Santi's celebration after he crosses to Giroud?
Yeah.
Oh, brilliant. My God.
Retweet that, Jace.
Just catching up with some people. Just followed Dwayne and his Mrs. Beth. Yeah, they're off. He's off to spend some time with her because I think she might divorce him because he spent the last 3 hours listening to us being twats. Oh, someone's just said,
and I will say,
can you start again so you don't know? Oh, you said that, didn't you? Go on.
No, we can't.
Have you retweeted that?
Dom, and a little aside, Dom has said to check the WhatsApp.
Ah, there we go.
That Sandy Vine is just brilliant. Metal Goon has retweeted it as well, so I'll
Oh my god, it's beautiful, isn't it?
Just
oh.
That little jig he does. Just
Jesus, yes.
Yeah, if you want to come on. Oh, sorry. Yes, if you want.
Who are you talking to, Danny?
Dom.
Oh, I thought you'd lost the plot.
No, I'm you know me. I tend to say what I'm reading rather than just reading it to myself.
We know you.
Yeah, so is
Yeah, Dom, come on, you mong. Dong mong.
Who's changed the room of depravity? What is that picture?
That picture was one I put up about an hour ago.
Was it a picture of?
It's a picture of somebody teabagging somebody.
Oh, for God's sake.
What?
I don't need to see pictures like that, do I?
Well, don't look at it then.
I'm not.
That was the whole thing that me and the other Jeff were laughing about last week whenever Kate was talking about Teabag and the Witch.
yeah, Teabag the Witch, yeah. Danny, you need to invite Dom, please.
That's good.
Okay, I shall go to here. And then
we
here.
All need a bit of sexiness.
And then we go to here, and then I go and get his thing, which is his Gmail address. I then go to Hangouts.
Good
and then
mate.
Go to here. And then go and paste it in there because Google Hangouts is shit. What? If you just type in Dom, it doesn't work.
Dom. Oops,
he's disappeared.
Sorry, I've disappeared, yeah. Just trying to pull my cable out, which is not a euphemism.
I thought maybe you're doing another pod as well as this one at the same time, another sub-podding. Here he is. Oh, Domsky's there.
Oh, Christ.
He's looking well. He's a bit blue. Oh, Jason's gone.
He's in bed. There's Jason.
Oh, no, there he is.
Coming back.
Who's in bed?
Base station has gone downhill. that's the best one of the day there, Connor Bork. That's awesome. Hang on. I can get my... there you go. Sorry.
I'm back, by the way.
Yeah, are you off, Jace?
No, he's there. Dom's there as well.
I'm back.
Oh,
look
at you.
You handsome bastard.
Oh,
you
sexy Dom.
He wakes up and he's still prettier than all of us, and we've been awake for 12 hours.
What time is it, Dom?
It is 4:39 a.m.
Look at you, all got all arsenaled up.
There we go, we're on.
Hey, what were your thoughts on the game, Mr. Dom?
It's
alright.
It was pretty enjoyable in the end, wasn't it? I still really? Thought somehow with the self-destruct button that we were hovering over that we were going to press at some point, but we managed to avoid that, which was nice.
So did we. Oh, Christ, Jace is on the Guinness. Anything could happen.
He can't even hold it straight.
No.
Who was your man of the match, Dom?
Pardon?
Who was your man of the match? Because I think I might go for Montreal.
Oh, Santi. No, yeah? I'll go Santi. Yeah.
Santi.
Definitely
up there. Santi, yeah. Gotta be up there.
It also shows that we're just not a one-man team. If it's not, if Sanchez doesn't score, then people are thinking that without him we're knackered. I think Sanchez was quite quiet today.
He was very quiet, yeah.
Well, yeah, well, I think, you know, when we're playing a counter-attacking style of game, he was never going to be involved as much as usual, was he?
No.
He was at centre-back, he was at left-back, he was all over the pitch. What a player.
Mm. He's just a hugely talented player. And in that central role, because, I mean, Ozil doesn't get in at the moment, does he?
Yeah. It's true. But there again, I was saying, oh, Suarez just had one cleared off the line. Is it Suarez?
No, it's Messi.
Oh, right, of course, it's too far away.
Anyway.
You could do, yeah.
Should give notable nods to Monreal and Coquelin as well.
Fantastic.
And Bellerin as well.
We should have a look and see. Look good.
The entire defense played really, really well today.
Yeah, absolutely. And Ospina kept his place, and rightly so as well. And did everything that was asked of him, look comfortable, look confident, took crosses when he needed to. But we said, didn't we, during the live commentary, that they were playing in front, the first half, they were playing in front of us all the time. You know, they've passing side to side, but they never ever looked. We never looked in any trouble, did we? Really, I can't think of any clear.
Early in the second half, we were opened up a little bit. I think we might have come out a little bit. I don't know. I think no, maybe not slow. I think we got a little bit too keen to get forward and maybe score that second goal. And if you don't finish off the move, then you've left a lot of space in midfield when you commit players forward. So.
I didn't realise because she only got booked in the third minute.
Yeah.
Bloody hell, that's...
Yeah.
That's terrible. I'm just looking at the Opta stats. Man of the match, they gave Cthulhu 10 out of 10.
Yeah.
Next best was Monreal, 9.3. Giroud, 8.5. Ospina, 8. Sanchez, 7.9. Sanchez, 7.7. And they say our quietest man of the match was that played was the Ox with 7 and Ramsey with 7.3. I think that's fair.
Yeah, I think that's fair.
Rosicky only got a 6.8. I know he wasn't on for long, but
did well.
Better than that. And the highest rated Man City player was Zabaleta with 7.4.
I will say, Santi, I know you're talking about. Are you on who scored, Danny?
Yeah.
Yeah. Santi Cazorla, definitely.
Yeah.
You're talking about key passes 2, assists 1, goals 1. Just the way that he controlled the game, really from our third into their third, the way he was involved in almost every instrumental move of us breaking into their half of the field. And when you really realize what he's done for us the last probably 6 weeks, so far he's probably one of my players of the year. I know Alexis is having a great year and doing everything and scoring and assisting, but the way that Santi is linking the defense with the way we're attacking now has got to be noticed, because he's doing it in such an unbelievable way right now. I'm sorry, looking at Dom is really distracting because he's so sexy. but the way that Santi has been able, like I said, especially the last 6 weeks, the way that he's been able to control the game himself, change pace, better make our rhythm either slower if it needs to be slower or speed it up if it needs to be faster. The way that he's playing is very, I think, understated right now, and he needs to be given the credit due.
I am here, as the child decided to cover up the camera so that it could... Hello. So it could leave the room. Yeah, very good. Are you a little bit tired, Dom? Will you be up for the rest? What time did you get up at to watch the game?
4 o'clock in the morning, of course he's tired.
No, 2:30. It started here.
So have you had any sleep at all?
I had a little bit of a nap before the game.
Dom, show everybody what you're drinking, by the way. Show them what you're drinking.
What ill?
Water.
To show them what I'm drinking. Six in now, boys.
Hot chocolate with marshmallows.
What time is it there, Jace? What time is it?
Of course. Right now it is 1:15 p.m.
Beer o'clock.
Yeah.
We truly are global tonight. America, UK, Aussie, we're everywhere.
It's the future over here. Do you want me to give you the lotto numbers, Jace?
Oh, please.
Tim from South Africa,
who is soon to join us for one of these, is there. Sorry, Tim, I've not been fucking up. People are going mad. Questions from here. I'll just scroll back a little bit. That's Dom. That's Matt Edwards. I'm not here for a post-match rundown. I don't know what that means. I am. Stand the man 450. Talk bollocks. Strip off. Do whatever you want. We just beat City.
In relation to the Babe Station comment.
What, child? I can't keep fucking doing it. I can't keep doing
it. Tell her to pop out and say hello.
Yeah.
You're such an annoying tit. I'll have you pissing adopted. It's done. Yes, it is. Tim Hargreaves says, evening, fellas. The post-match tactic analysis just finished here. Antoine, Dom Reevils.
Danny, Dom your Rivals, camera. Giroux, what? Your camera is...
I know. It's because the Muppet wants to go in the kitchen and behind me.
Just checking.
Dom rivals Giroux for looks, for man. And that says Alexis was quiet, but he done his job perfectly today. Yep. Just shows what a quality player he is. The Oz FIFA, you take it you know him, Dom, because he's Aussie.
Yeah,
he lived next door. City hadn't lost in 12 matches or been held. I ain't touching dead chicken. No, piss off.
I think that's something that needs to be well stated, is the fact that we held Manchester City, who at one point had Jovetic, Dzeko, and Kun Aguero. We held them to a clean sheet this week, and that's got to be a credit to our defense and Ospina, who I think had all five of those Those guys had a great game. Obviously, you know, I practically caved in my pants whenever Bellerin was making those tackles. And you look at the positioning of Mertesacker, the ferocity in man marking that Koscielny had, and Montreal had a great game as well. And he's somebody who I'm not too fond of in our squad. But at the same time, they all five of them, Ospina as well, had a great game. And I think that doesn't need to go understated, the fact that they were able to hold such an attacking side without Yaya Toure. That does not matter. You look at the team that they put out, and that's a great football team that they placed out on the pitch tonight. And we allowed them to have possession, but we dominated the game, I think, from the first whistle to the last.
The better side won, 100%. And that's what, three clean sheets in a row, is that? I think it is. Stoke, Hull, and City. So, and it puts paid to the idea that the manager doesn't have any tactics. You know, just put that out there. All these people that say we don't set up right, we clearly learnt from last year, the 6-3. We clearly, like Dom said, we set up to sort of nullify them as well as have the opportunity to get goals either on the break or with chances. But like I said earlier, like I genuinely, other than Dom was right, second half they came out with a little bit of spite and a little bit of motivation to try and get back in the game early. But we never really looked under any considerable threat, I didn't think. It was going to be lucky for them to get back in it.
Another tweet from a good friend of the pod, I assume, a guy named Mesut Ozil 1088. For some reason, he has a verified check by his name. Mesut Ozil, wow, 2-0 at the Etihad. Great performance from the whole team. Ya Gunners, ya, hashtag, come on, COYG, hashtag. MCFC versus AFC. So you look at the whole team benefits from a win like this. Because we can finally put to rest the Arsenal don't perform against the big three, the Chelsea, the United, the City. Even the 6-3 loss last year, we performed well. They just performed better than we did and scored more goals than we did. And for us to finally perform well and win, I think is really going to be a boost to the whole team in a great way. I know it's the 18th of January 2015, but it's a great way to continue to build on this 2015 season, 2014, 2015, and to go into the rest of this season and say, look, 2014 was its own year. It's in the past. We can't do anything about it. 2015 is our season. It's our year, and we can do something about these results. Let's take it into our own hands and attack teams and play to our strengths against teams where it really works and defend and counter against teams where we need to defend and counter. And I think we showed that today, that we have a versatility in our style of play that we could show the rest of the season and set up against in the rest of our season against teams who are quote-unquote better than us on paper, which really to me would only be Chelsea. And really take it to them and try to get a good result from it.
Two awesome stats got for you. One is that Arsenal's win today is the first time that they've won away to the defending champions since 2002. There's a stat for you. Wow. And the other one on Francis Coquelin, 7 headers, 88%, 2 tackles, 100%, 6 interceptions, 11 clearances, 3 blocks. I mean, you know, this is a guy that wasn't even at the club 3 weeks ago, and now all of a sudden he's becoming one of the first names on the team sheet, and fully justified as well. He was good
again
today. No one
saw that coming, not even Wenger, did they?
I think Wenger obviously would have seen it coming, that he believed in him enough to put him in, but...
Do you reckon that loan move to Charlton was just to get him fit?
Possibly.
With a view to playing him more?
Possibly, yeah, possibly. And maybe it was sometimes when you're on your ass and you've got no other options, sometimes putting somebody in and just putting faith in them can get you results. Sometimes it can go completely the opposite way, Balotelli. But if you sometimes you just got to give that person a chance. And Coquelin is never going to be Iniesta and Xavi, but what he does well. And he's tigerish, and he's mobile, which is a big part of how we play. If we've got somebody who's who's mobile enough to get back in and help the defence, then it limits the amount of time we get caught upfield with our Flamini's or our Tetas, who sometimes go walkies and haven't actually got the legs to get back. Whereas Coquelin, I can't remember ever seeing him in their half today or at any point when he's played. He just sits in that.
He's done an anti-song.
Yeah, yeah. And
although
he seems,
Song was man of the match for West Ham today.
Yeah, he was. He seems to, the thing I like about Coquelin as well is he seems to be one of those players that enjoys tackling. Which you like
we
when
saw
you
the
see
way
like
the face on him.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's like he's overdone the roids. Mm. But yeah, it's just fantastic.
Let Dom have something to say as well. Say something, Dom.
What do you want from me, Kris?
Everything and anything.
It's 4:30 in the morning, for Christ's sake.
Everything and anything.
That was the first time that we went away. Well, actually, no, against Liverpool we were sort of a little bit more defensive, but I don't think that was due to a tactic more than it was that we just didn't really show up for that game. So it was the first time I've really noticed that we... And, you know, it's always... When teams do it to us, we find it really difficult to break down. You can have a team of, you know, so-so players, but if they manage to work together really well and organise themselves really well defensively, it doesn't matter who you are, it's hard to break down. Mm. So the other thing that we've got, though, is we've got that quality going forward that some of those other teams don't have, where if you've got an Alexis or a Ramsey and, you know, if you bring a Theo on or an Oxlade-Chamberlain, we've got the quality to finish off some of those counter-attacking moves. So I'm not sure why we haven't done it a little bit more often, and I hope that we do employ it, especially away from home, in certain games, just to soak up a little bit of the initial pressure and sting a couple of teams, because you know that if you start doing it, teams are going to have to think twice about committing players forward.
Yeah, I agree with that. And
so it can take pressure off by knowing what you've got up your sleeve and how dangerous you can be. So
we've got to take
that we do
on,
use
we?
It. Mm.
We can't now go, right, well, we've beaten City and, you know, suddenly we've won the league and pack it all up and go home. This has got to be built on now. You know, we've got Brighton next week, which, okay, granted, is a cup game, but we've got to go into that with this momentum, and then we've got to come, we got home to Villa, and then we're away to that lot up the road, which, if they keep winning and we keep winning, could be a really pivotal game, particularly away from home. If we play like we did today, you know, we won't lose games away from home.
I said after the pod that we did on Thursday, when the post pod chat, I said, if you look back at the last game we lost was Southampton, and then the game before that was Stoke. So after Stoke, we played Galatasaray, beating 4-1. So if we're taking that as the first game, we could go on a run of one defeat in 23 games, which would be the Southampton game. So at the moment, we've lost one in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We've lost one in the last 8. So I reckon we can go another 15 games without a defeat. The only tough ones is maybe going to be Liverpool and Spurs, and that's it. The rest of the teams we're playing, we could easily win every game up until middle of April.
But you say, you know, this that's just what I was just saying. Like, we can't now sit there and go, right, well, you know, we've done it and great, there's a lot of games. We can't now switch off and go, oh well, it's only Villa at home. As I said earlier, like, Villa can't even score, so we should beat them at home. Yeah. But we can't go into those games with that attitude of, well, we beat Man City away, therefore we'll be all right at home to Villa, because it would be typically us.
Brighton is 6 o'clock on a Sunday, which means it's probably going to be on TV.
Yeah, it is. Yeah,
and Villa is 1:30 on Sunday. That's TV. Mm-hmm. And then Spurs is 12:45 on a Saturday. That's TV. Mm-hmm. Leicester won't be. Palace won't be. That's 3 o'clock on Saturday. Monaco will be. Mm-hmm. Sunday, 2:05, Everton. That will be on TV.
Yeah.
QPR won't. That's midweek. And then, so we've got about 4 or 5 more games coming up that we can bore people with talking shit, talking to ourselves as if we haven't got nearly 10 people watching.
Yeah, talking like there's no one else around. But yeah, it's all about momentum now. And somebody asked a question right at the start of this, who you would play in the Brighton game. I think there will be some rotation, but I would largely stick with... In fact, weirdly, maybe the Brighton game would be the time to get your Ozils.
Take Sanchez out.
Yeah, maybe that would be the game to
Cots
get that
won't
in.
Play, Sanchez won't play. I'd let Ospina play, or maybe let Martinez play just to piss Chesney off a little bit more.
Oh, I would probably give Chesney that game, to be fair.
No, I wouldn't. I mean, he's completely dropping. Wenger's using him as not a scapegoat, but as to show people, don't fuck with me or you're not playing.
Why is he on the bench then? That'll be my argument. If that's
don't
the
breathe
case.
In while you're drinking hot chocolate with marshmallows.
Especially with spiders in it.
I didn't check for spiders.
Because it'd be worse sitting on the bench watching.
Yeah, especially with Martinez.
Sitting on the bench watching the other guy out there keep clean sheets would really have to fuck you off, wouldn't it?
Three in a row. Three clean sheets in a row for him now.
Yeah. I think Chesney will play at Brighton. I do. Whether we think it's right or not, I think he probably will.
Yeah, but I think what will happen now is that... I think you're right, Chris. I think that Chesney will now be the number two keeper, much like Fabianski was last year, and play the cup games.
Yep.
And I think that Ospina will be the number... Yeah, will be the number one until, you know, he does something to lose the job. And he hasn't really been tested. He hasn't really been peppered.
No.
And they haven't really put a lot of pressure on him in any of the three games that he's played. But... In saying that, we've had three clean sheets, so, you know, you don't drop a guy that's keeping clean sheets.
He does the basics well, doesn't he, Dom? That's the thing I like with Ospina. I mean, you know, even when he was in the French League, he just does those simple things well. He looks like a big bloke. He looks like he's not going to be intimidated. When he comes for a cross, he comes with, you know, he comes with authority. And he just, and the other thing I like is even just the very simple things, like when we were last 10 minutes where they were trying to get the goal back. He'd come out, he'd claim a cross, and he'd fall on it, and he'd just lay there for a few minutes, you know, a few seconds. Just takes the sting out of it. You know, if that's Chesney, he gets the ball immediately, he's looking to get us on the move, which, okay, is fine when we're chasing a game, but it's game management. And Ospina so far, like you say, in the limited sort of time that we've seen him, he's done everything completely comfortably. And he's was it you, Danny, that said he just keeps goal? Which is what you want your goalkeeper to do.
He's not doing the Morris dancing. Ellis Mail was just put that will Hairy Ballbag be making an appearance?
I hope not.
Oh, who is that bloke? Let's find out who he was.
It was a gentleman off the Facebook page and his surname was Ballbeck, not Ballbag.
Ballbeck. That's that reminds me of something that's maybe in a film? I don't know. You're very quiet, Jace. Is that because you're drunk? You're sitting back contemplating life, figuring out where it all went wrong, where the six-pack went?
No. Never had the six-pack to wonder even where it went. just looking at Twitter right now and...
Don't tell me people are happy.
Yeah, it's really fucking... Like, I'm taken aback by it. I'm speechless by how amazing Twitter is right now after we just played Manchester City in Manchester, and it's a feeling we haven't had a lot recently as Gooners and fans of the Arsenal, is being able to celebrate after beating a top three or four side, and now we're here, and it's just I'm just soaking up the feeling, really. You know, nothing, not trying to let it go, you know, fleetingly into the night that, oh, we beat City, oh, fuck, we've got, you know, whoever. I don't even give a fuck who we play next week at this moment. I'll worry about that tomorrow or Tuesday. I'm just going to sit and bask in this 3 points that we have right now, and of course, bask in Dom's presence that we have right now for as long as I can. And I really truly hope that we can continue to build on this because it was a great performance, and I think it's something that we can, the whole team, the coaching staff, the fans can all take comfort in saying, hey, we can do this. We've known we can do it for a long time and we haven't, but we know we can do it and we did today. And taking that solace and that comfort and beating a team like City. I don't give a shit that Yaya Toure was out. I really don't. People are like, oh, Yaya Toure wasn't out. Fuck, Arsenal's still shit. Unbelievable.
What kind of accent was that?
Yeah, that was supposed to be my City accent. My Midlands accent. It works, whatever. but yeah, I really hope that we can all sort of just
sit in here and just be happy as Arsenal fans together for what our team has done today. Because that really was one of the best performances of the season. And I've been saying the whole season, possession, just like you said earlier, possession doesn't mean anything anymore. It's not like it's 2005 when if you have possession, you're in control of the game. Now you can concede as much possession as you want and still be the best team on the day. And we were, and it showed. And it's been a long time since we've been able to say that we've conceded possession, been the best team, and deserve to win. And we did today, and I think that's something all Gunners and all Gooners and all Arsenal fans, whether you're in Chile or Peru or Australia in Adelaide or in North Carolina or in England or in wherever you want to fucking be, I don't care. Let's fucking celebrate, and let's enjoy it for a day and not have all this negative shit. Even though people say I'm negative because I'm banging around, I don't give a fuck today. I'm Arsenal first, and that's all I care about. And we won today, and that's what's the most important thing.
Wenger,
so
I'm buzzing
beyond the alcohol.
Yeah, me too. I'm buzzing on hot chocolate and marshmallows
and spiders.
And spider boxes, yes, spider box.
Go on, Dom.
Hashtag spider box.
Chase gets a little bit handsy when he's had a few drinks, hasn't he? Doesn't he?
If only you were here.
No, you're spot on though, Jace. You are spot on. I think it's really good to see a performance for the whole team. That there was no passengers, yeah. No one got carried. Everyone put in a shift, and you know it doesn't matter if you're playing Man City away or if you're playing, Brighton and Hove at home in a yeah. cup game. It doesn't really matter. You've got to do that. Everyone has to put in. You can't afford passengers at that level. And, like you said, with people saying how Yaya Toure and Nasri were out, but have a look at what they can do. They've got Dzeko on the bench. They've got Milner. They've got Frank Lampard. I mean, yeah. We had a 19-year-old kid at right back who played his ass off. We had a guy that we recalled from loan playing in defensive midfielder who had an absolute blinder. And, you know, I was even one of those people that was a little bit, you know, I wasn't down on Coughlin at all. I just wanted to reserve my judgment for
Chris,
a game where
say it.
He had to. What's he done?
You said you're down on the Coughlin. Don't say it. Go ahead, Dom. Ignore these facts.
Your wife is down on the cock. Oi.
This is going to turn to shit in another 45 minutes or so with Jace just sitting there smashing pints. But no, I was one of those people that thought, you know, I'll reserve judgment until he had to come up against a team that were going to put him under a lot of pressure and make him, you know, those split-second decisions, how was he going to... It's all about, you know, how calm is he in the head as far as making those last-ditch tackles. When do you commit yourself? When do you not commit yourself? And he didn't really put a foot wrong today, so you've got to take your hat off and say, well, you know, what more can the kid do? It's all about opportunity, isn't it? If you're a manager and you give a guy an opportunity, all you can ask for is that they go out there and they do their best to take it. And everybody that got a start today is going to make sure they make it very, very difficult for the manager to not leave him to leave him out of the team sheet for the next game. Mm-hmm. And that's all you can ask, regardless of age, regardless of experience, regardless of that it's, you know, against Manchester City who have... you know, very, very deep pockets. And I guess that's where a lot of the frustration lies over the last, you know, few years when it comes to playing those bigger sides, especially away from home, is that the performances, whilst, you know, yes, we've been a little bit unlucky here and there, I can't remember a performance like that where everyone put in a big shift and everyone made sure that they didn't want to let the person next to them down. And, you know, hopefully, fingers crossed, that flows on to the next few games. But hopefully it flows on to the players that were on the bench and the squad players that didn't actually get a game today so they know what the expectation is when they come into the team.
Yeah, well said.
Can I just give a big shout-out to and Gimli actually shouted him out, and then he got another shout-out on Gooners on the mic, is Mark J. Fine, who's giving us a watch right now. And great Gooner. If you don't follow him, then you're not Twittering right. You're not doing it right. Follow at Mark J. Fine because he's a great guy up in Virginia. Great guy. So yeah, he's watching. So I just wanted to say that because he's been a good friend of mine on Twitter for the last probably 2 years. And fuck Dom, what Dom says sober, I couldn't put as eloquently sober, much less off of 6 pints here. But yeah, it really is a day that we need to look back on this day and hold our team to this standard because we know we can play this well now against the top team, as well as we just need to enjoy it because we haven't had a whole lot of days like this season that we could enjoy. So, yeah.
Enjoy. I'm with you. I'm going to be walking around at work harder than a Rubik's Cube later on. I don't even care.
Not enough for a t-shirt.
Easy. Every lady in Adelaide just melted.
That's a really good...
Can we ask some questions, Kris, if you can? Because I'm just retweeting stuff.
I'll ask some questions. I want to just give a quick shout to a tweet I've just noticed, which was from Michael Cox at Zona Marking, where he's put, a rare Vincent Kompany error, in quote marks, is fast becoming the new a rare Pepe Reina error. Spot on. Fucking spot on. I know you two took the piss out of me when I said the company's overrated, and I know Dom will call me a hipster. But
he is. There's a heat map going around of Sagna's heat map.
Yeah.
Sat on the bench.
Quality. And I'm glad the referee was strong enough to give that penalty, because I know many, many referees that wouldn't have been strong enough to give that. You know, company was a deliberate movement at the body to cut Monreal off. You know, it was a penalty. There can be no debate about that. And it's about time that referees decided to give that. Whether that has anything to do with the fact that Debussy got shoved last week and he was looking for shoves this week, who knows? But it's a misconception that blocking off is not an offence, and it is. You know, it's obstruction, and when you're in the penalty area, that is a penalty. And then obviously Santi struck away the penalty very well. He seems to be our regular taker now, and long may it continue. But no, I just thought I'd give a little nod to Vincent, overrated company. What have we got in the chat?
Oh, egghead.
No, egghead. Mars attacks.
What did we all think of the substitutions?
I loved them.
Yeah, I thought they were about right. I think the only one that we called during the live play was we thought Theo for the last 20 minutes would have been... We thought that's what would happen because we thought they would push. Yeah, when they brought Xhaka on, they blatantly had essentially 6 forwards or 5 forward players. We thought that would be the time. But you know what? You know, the manager was spot on. And when you 2-0 up with 20 to go and you've been playing as well as that, we didn't need to go for a third goal. We were quite happy to sit in front. And the Gibbs and... Flamini substitutions were, again, probably right. I think Alexis deserved the break. You know, he had a quiet game today, but he always took a marker away. He always opened up space for others, which people probably will miss when they look back at the game. They won't realise how much work he does, even though he didn't have the ball, takes players away and gives players like Santi the space. And I think the Gibbs substitution was really just get somebody on who's quite quick to shield the left back.
And if you're just now tuning in and didn't tune in during the game, I said it during the match when Gibbs came on. This is what we did during our really successful run at the beginning of last year, was had either Monreal or Gibbs come on as a defensive substitute later in the match with the other one on. Mm. On that left side, we were so defensive because obviously a majority of the players in the Premier League are right-footed. They're going to try to get that cross in. When you either have Gibbs at left back or Monreal at back, and you put one of those two in front of them, we become so much better defensively later in games. And that, I think, was one of the key things because Zabaleta has been one of the best right backs in the league for the last couple of years. I don't think anybody can really deny that. And we really took him out of the game, especially later in the game when they were trying to just hoof balls long. We really took away that right side of the field to make them change their tactics and go more centrally into the left side, which I don't think is their strongest area. And you've got to credit Wenger for that. And I wish he would do it more. I do. But at the same time, it's all about today, and I'm so happy we were able to do that, bring Flamini on, and really just solidify not only the clean sheet, but what was a really dominant win over a really good, really, really good football team.
Mm. And we also Kun Aguero didn't get sniffed, did he? I mean, we seem to
who? Who
exactly? The one in Koz's pocket, that guy. And I think somebody made it. I think the Sky pundits made the case before the game that Aguero is one of those players that he's a. Dom, you probably know more about this than I would, but judging by the muscular injuries he's had and that, he seems to be one of those players that needs a few weeks before he gets up to his optimum levels, and that showed up today. He was thrust in at the deep end, and he looked very much like a player that was not quite there. But that being said, Koscielny marked him out of the game, and Mertesacker, who you would look at to be the one that maybe would be had on toast, he didn't have a lot to do, really, did he? I mean, he was fairly...
No, I think a lot of it came from the protection that Koscielny got in front of him as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, everybody was so... You go back to that game and you have a look at certain points of it, and there was just banks of four, if not, you know, four and five. Everyone was just moving together and stuff. So it just made it so... Aguero didn't have room to run in the first place, but not only that, the people that were trying to pass him the ball didn't have anywhere to pass into. So you cut the supply line to someone like Aguero, and if you look statistically, he's got 14 goals. Is it 14 or 15 goals? Two assists or something?
Sounds about right,
so he's he's someone that relies on other people feeding him the ball and him finishing off the moves, whereas Alexis is a little bit different, where he's got seven or something assists with his... 12 goals,
work.
So yeah, exactly right. But he'll also drop in and get the ball and have that pass, where I think Aguero for the whole game is looking to make those runs, and he's not someone that's going to drop deep to get himself into the game. So if you can cut off the supply line, you can really make sure that you sort of nullify the danger. Because, I mean, look, you're right. When you're coming back from a muscular injuries like that, and not only that, he's got repeat injuries to different areas. Every time he comes back, he seems to do something else. And I really like Aguero. I can't not like the guy. He's such an amazing player. Mm. You do need 2 to 3 weeks to start for the rehab process to be sort of, you know, classed a bit of a success, I guess. So it's the same thing with Ramsey today. He looked like he was clutching at his calf a little bit towards the end, and he was laying on the ground. I don't think it was cramp, because you'd be stretching that straight away, and he didn't really look too happy. He kind of looked a little bit frustrated when he was coming off. Mm. So don't be surprised if he may have picked up a little something in the calf, and that's that same thing. You know, he hasn't had any calf issues, but it's kind of a byproduct of doing rehab for an area and just how difficult it is to come back from soft tissue injuries. It is really, really difficult, especially at that elite level. So, I mean, fingers crossed it's absolutely nothing. He might have got a kick in the ankle, but... we'll have to wait and see. But yeah, Aguero, I mean, on his day, he's unplayable regardless, isn't he? But at the same time, if you work really hard as a team defensively like we did, and you stop the supply line, it makes it hard for anybody, doesn't it?
Yeah, I agree. Totally agree.
Just something that we saw just before up on the chat box, someone mentioned about Monreal and how he's had a pretty decent little patch of form lately. Not that I'm not saying that he hasn't. He's been absolutely fantastic. But you've also got to remember that the left side of our team last year always had a Podolski or maybe a Santi or someone in front of him who wasn't really giving him a whole lot of help. Yeah. So and teams were. It's the same thing that Liverpool did. And even Swansea did to our right-hand side, and we've got a young, inexperienced guy there. You put 2 3-on-1s over there, you go and overload that side. It's not rocket science. Mm. So that was happening a lot to us last year in that left-hand side. So Monreal found himself 2-on-1 so often. It doesn't matter how good left-back you are. It's not much you can do about that. But this year, he's got Alexis in front of him for a lot of the games. And that makes a hell of a difference when you've got someone that works back and tracks back and does a lot of the work for you before it gets to you. It makes your job a hell of a lot easier. So,
and he's also, I think that spell at centre back has toughened him up. He looks like he looks like a tougher player. He looks a little bit more muscular, and he looks a little bit more like he can contend with a fight. You know, so if a player is given a bit of rough and tumble, he doesn't just roll over now and let him pass. He seems to have learnt the dark arts of it better. He's closer to the man. He marks tighter. He puts a foot in. As did Bellerin today as well, which is really encouraging, because we didn't mention this at the start, but, you know, Ospina, okay, he got the nod over Chesney, we expected that, but I genuinely didn't think that Bellerin would get the nod over Chambers today, and he did, and he thoroughly deserved it on that performance. He stepped up, and whilst he still looks like quite a small, well, he is a small young lad, I think he's got some filling out to do, But he made some really good tackles. Interceptions were good. He read the game well. And his pace is always going to trouble the player opposite marking him when he comes forward. So he deserves a nod as well today.
Can I just say, Sim, on the chat as well, but obviously Simply Enigmatic on Twitter is his Twitter. It's great. A great guy. He's on the Goonosphere. Great guy. I just put Mike Dean had a good game. Runs and hide.
True.
But I actually do think he did have a decent game today. And it's very rare to say that he does that, especially when he's up against the Arsenal.
Mm. Yeah. And like we said earlier, that penalty, that was a strong call to make, particularly away from home. It would have been really easy to bottle that decision, but he didn't. You know, he made the decision, yeah. and it was the right call. It wasn't like we got lucky there. It was the right call. It was a penalty for me, and also he booked a few, not just the obvious ones like Aguero's pullback, but there was a few that he booked that were rightly booked.
There you go. Shall I read some of the comments? Because we've got 20 minutes left to go.
Yeah, where's Dom gone?
Oh, I'm not looking at the live thing, am I?
Mm. Dom's left. I'm the hottest.
Dom.
might have to add him back in.
Might be some chubby chasers out there.
Hey. It's all right here.
Go and get Dom's email. And then here. And then click there. And here. And invite.
I will say there. There's some great chat in the YouTube chats right now.
That's what I was going to do. Read some out from there if you can find
it. Really good. Yeah. So I actually asked, is anyone as gone as me? Tim put Jason. No, don't drink anymore. I wish I hadn't. That kind of Tim Hargraves did put company should have seen red. Agree, disagree at some point. Yeah, definitely a yellow. Probably with the two yellows he had, probably should have been. Yeah.
Here he is, Dom's back.
There he is.
Everybody can feel insignificant again.
And the thing is, his brains and beauty is doubly fucking annoying. Yes.
Yeah.
And still young. Fucker.
And would put, I thought Dean was really harsh on Kaz at the start, but he stayed consistent the whole game, so that's all we can ask for. I completely agree with that. He was consistent.
Do you notice him hobbling as well?
Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, and it's tough. Let's not act like being a referee is an easy thing to do. It's extremely difficult, especially the pace of the game now. Our good friend at Jason Davis put Mike Dean... Actually, you put fucking Mike Dean is a, in all caps, cunt, C-U-N-T.
He's so eloquent, isn't he?
You're not going to tell him he's wrong now, are you?
Some Welsh justice right there.
That's Philippe Fallop to you, Jace.
How comes Jason hasn't asked to come on? Why isn't Jason said
on? His camera's broke, and if he
His
comes,
camera's not broke, he can get on his phone.
And also,
he did with me and Dom yesterday.
If he comes on, the internet breaks.
That's so it.
Yeah. I will say, Sim also put
Simi
Jason
Savile.
Is so way.
Poor bastard.
Sim Savile put Jason is so wasted. More shots. No shots, Jay or Sim. Only good brews. I'm just a lightweight, so six beers is definitely my limit. Because my wife's going to be somewhat disappointed later this afternoon. let's see. And what put Jeff and GFPR, I think. Any of you guys against Arsene Wenger put Samat Singh? To be honest with you, Samat, I am Wenger out. I am. I, on a long time, was one of those guys who was on the fence about it. Now I think he should go. I don't think he's terrible, but I there's so much stuff that he could improve upon / change that I don't think he will, because it's worked in the past. And to be honest with you, what's worked in the past doesn't always work today. And so I do think that there are times when he's great for the club, when he's signing guys like Sanchez, who said they signed because he's Wenger. Ozil said the same thing. You know, Christian Birek has said the same thing. Or Bollock, whatever, Cock and Bollock in the midfield. But I do think it's time for us to transition to somebody who can take us to the next level. I do feel that Wenger has hit a glass ceiling. And I'll actually pose that question, Dom and Danny. What are your feelings on Wenger? And do you think, especially, it's tough to say after a win, but do you think Wenger is sort of done, or do you think he's still got something left in the tank?
I'll go. I'm back, by the way. Can't get rid of me. I'm like herpes. It's a tough one for me because I'll be honest, I don't really care. It's out of my control. You know, I like to just sit and enjoy the games. I don't really like to let myself get too emotional on, you know, the uncontrollable things like who the manager is or, you know, what he's up to. Obviously, I've got opinions on things. I think that for as wonderful as he has been and for as many great things that he has potentially still got up his sleeve, there are still some things that I'd personally like to see change, but who am I? You know, sometimes you just got to really be really critical of your opinion and you know, question where it's coming from and the reasons behind it, because that's the one criticism I have for staunch Wenger supporters, as well as the people that are just really, really against him, is that you'll use anything possible to either beat him with or to flog him off with. So it's not a critical analysis, and that's where I get really annoyed, and I can't be bothered getting into the conversation all that much, just because a lot of the people that you're having a conversation with aren't critical. So, you know, at least you, Jace, you can sit there and go, you know what, credit to the guy. He rocked up today to Manchester City after we've been not so great away from home, and he changed the game plan completely, and it worked. You mean you can't not take your hat off to that, and you can't not give him credit. I heard one of the commentators say something about, oh, Steve Ball must have, you know, and you just think, Jesus Christ, even the commentators are doing it. But you know, for me it's like I said, I really don't try. I try as hard as I can to not get too caught up in the whole thing. But, you know, like Kris has said a million times, it doesn't really matter what you think. He's going to be there until he feels like leaving. But you sometimes as well, you know, you look at the Alexis Sanchez's and the Mesut Ozil's and the resurgence and the form that we had with Aaron Ramsey and the player we now have with Aaron Ramsey. I doubt very much there would be many managers in the world that would be able to get out of Aaron Ramsey what Arsene Wenger has gotten out of him, because most people would have just benched him and or sold him or, you know, just flogged him off by now. So it mean, like I said, you know, you don't really know what you've got till it's gone, because you don't know how much influence he has over players staying, players wanting to come. Ozil and Sanchez both said it, that they came because they wanted to work with him. You know, and Sanchez had the option of going to a lot of other clubs, and he chose Arsenal. So he's still a big draw, and he's got a lot of things that I like. But there's also, like I said, you know, things like in the transfer market, I'll never forgive him for going into this season with only two centre-backs. Chambers wasn't bought as a centre-back. Otherwise, we wouldn't have lent Jenkinson out on loan. So you're going into the season with only two centre-backs and not a good enough, for me anyway, a good enough defensive midfielder, frustrates me, because all I want and all my expectations are of the club is that we will go into each season giving ourselves the best chance possible to compete. I know that you've got City and Chelsea that are going to spend, you know, twice, three times as much as what you do regardless, but I just want to make sure that we do everything that we can to compete, and I don't think we did that this season. So, you know, like I said, there's a lot of things that I'm still frustrated about. But at the same time, there are a lot of things that he does that are, you know, probably underrated and understated as well. What do you think, Danny? You seem to be a little bit more of an Arsene out person, but...
I think the problem for me with Arsene is his stubbornness, the regular substitutions at the same point. Yeah. I was making a big point today that in the past, Wenger, we would have been winning and then he would have brought on a striker. You don't do that. You bring on, you consolidate what you have. And I think the fact that he's let Coughlin go out and almost got rid of him, he's seen that he's playing well and he keeps playing him, rather than bringing back Flamini, because Flamini is the more senior player. He's learning his lesson from that. Tactics-wise, he's learning his lesson. He's not making substitutions all at the same time. The way that we're changing formation, we're playing our game differently. We're maybe adapting the game to who we're playing, so things like that. So if he continues to do that, he's learning from his mistakes, then yes, keep him. I'm perfectly happy with him. But like you say, as long as the team are winning, I don't really care what they do. But I just want to see that Wenger show that he isn't stuck in his ways and he isn't still doing the same stuff now that he was doing in 98. So if he continues to do this, and I'm happy, not that he's ever going anywhere, and not that anyone will ever listen to me if I say it's time for him to go, but he is definitely, things of the last month, 6 weeks, something has changed. I get the feeling the worm has turned. And we'll see when the window is closed, if we've backed up and bought the players that we need, then yeah, it's all going to be good.
The thing is as well, Danny, is that, you know, whether you're pro or against the manager, you know, people are enjoying the result today, and rightly so, and exactly what Jason and Dom said, we should just forget about it, all the whatever, and just enjoy results that are good. And I just retweeted a tweet from Kay, who I've spoken to before, saying that people are talking about signings for the squad after a big win like that. Can we not all just have a day off and enjoy yourself? And I think it is the mentality of the modern fan, is that, you know, everybody wants everything now. Everybody thinks that everything should be done now. All the signings should be done now. And people will never be happy. It's a greed mentality nowadays. And it doesn't matter whether we're winning every week or not. Make no mistake about it, if we now go and lose to Brighton, for example, it'll all turn again. So it changes by the day, sometimes by the hour. And like Dom said, it doesn't matter who's in charge. Like you said as well, Danny, it just doesn't matter who's in charge. If the team are performing, and we're enjoying our football, who cares? But equally, I'll stick by, and have done for a long time, I'll stick by the manager, because he's the right man for the job until a better man becomes available. And in my opinion, there isn't a better man out there to manage this club.
But that's the thing, Kris. In 1995, whenever we got rid of Bruce Rioch, who was a better man?
Oh, agree.
Who would you have said is best to take over the Arsenal? Nobody knew at the time.
I think times have changed, though. I don't think you could bring in a manager from Japanese football in 2015.
I'll say this though. How many Arsene Wengers are floating around out there?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah.
Regardless of where he was or what he was doing, I understand that. I understand that there's a lot of fear and there's a lot of comfortability with saying, we'll keep him because, you know, it's better the devil you know sort of thing. Whereas I can understand that, look, you know, nothing good ever comes from sitting in your comfort zone. You've always got to push those boundaries. But at the same time, I don't think that there are too many Arsene Wengers floating around out there, or, you know, potential Arsene Wengers. The guy is, regardless of what you think of him, you know, in recent times, he's an extremely intelligent man. He revolutionised the way that football is played and the way that it's done in the English game. But at the same time, like you said, is that now coming to an end? Has he now gone as far as he can now go? You know what? We won't know until he's left.
No, that's it. He won't be appreciated until he's gone either. No. And just talk to fans. Talk to any fan. Talk to Aston Villa fans or Hull fans. Or, you know, there are fans in leagues, not just in the UK, anywhere in the world, that would cut their bollocks off to have Arsene Wenger.
Talk to United fans a year ago.
Absolutely. You're talking some United fans even now, Jace. You know, you listen to people that they sit there and they go, Van Gaal is a bit of a joke.
My big issue is we cannot be afraid of change for the sake of change.
No, that's fair.
We have to get the best man in for the job, and I personally, I don't feel that it's Arsene Wenger who can win us. I do not feel that we will win another title with Arsene Wenger. At the same time, I don't watch enough European, continental, I don't even watch enough American football, really, to be honest with you, to know who the best coach is to take us forward. But that doesn't change the fact that I think there's somebody out there that somebody knows. Because here's the issue. We think about Ivan Gazidis going out and saying, hey, this is the coach. No, it's not. It's very much like college football in the U.S. You hire a search firm, and you give them a list of priorities that you have for your team, and you select the person who's best for those priorities. And the same thing happened in 1995 when we wanted to get rid of Bruce Rioch and we got Arsene Wenger, and the same thing can happen today. And I don't know if it's Jurgen Klopp. Just because a coach is having a bad year doesn't mean they're a bad coach. We don't know the circumstances that he has to work with. We don't know the injuries. I mean, some people who do follow Dortmund know the injuries he's had to deal with. But we cannot be afraid of what we have right now and just losing who was and do not get me wrong. Arsene Wenger was a revolutionary coach in English football. You know, 22 to 15 years ago. At this point, it seems to me that everybody's caught up with him and has surpassed him. And if I think it was Ray Parler who said there, the tactics are the same now and the practices and training sessions are the same now as they were in 1996. And if that's so, shame on Wenger.
They worked today, though, didn't they?
But
I mean, that's always the cross-argument, isn't it?
Correct, but at the same time, am I saying Arsene Wenger out on a loss? No.
Oh, no.
I'm not. I'm saying it after a beautiful performance by our players, and I don't think that he is as awful as most of the wobs think that he is. I think that he still has something in his tank. I just don't believe I don't believe what he has in his tank is enough to take us over to win the title in the Premier League right now in 2014-15.
And Danny,
that's why I want to see another coach in.
Danny, you'll tell us from experience running this podcast, you can't please everyone, can you?
No, you can't.
You never will be able to.
I was just thinking another thing. Do you think it made a big difference today? The back four looked less jittery because Chesney wasn't there.
Yeah, I agree. They look more comfortable. They're...
Wasn't it you who tweeted out or said in the WhatsApp group that Ospina has been such a calming influence in the back four. And Chesney is good at shouting and giving orders and everything, but is that calming?
Is that true? Well, it's not calming when you know that
organizing?
When you've got your back to goal and you don't know where the hell Chesney's going to be.
He's not doing calming. A Michael Flatterley, Lord of the Dance somewhere.
He's doing his Manuel Neuer impression, but terribly.
Yeah.
No. Just going back to what we were speaking about just for a second ago, I'll play devil's advocate for a minute with you, Jace. When go back to sort of 2003, 2004, did anybody, maybe a little bit earlier than that, did anybody predict what was going to happen with Chelsea and Man City?
No, but I did stop going.
And the way that they were going to change the landscape of not only English football, but transfers, player wages, you know, the player costs and things like that. Did anybody predict that?
I think you could see it a little bit because the way that you go, Chelsea were kind of a half-decent team in the first place, but what they used to do is go and buy anybody for any amount of money. Middlesbrough tried, it was Juninho and Fabrizio Ravanelli, where Ravanelli said, I want 50 grand a week, and they went, oh, okay. And he was like, well, I don't really want to leave Juventus, we just won the Champions League, but I'll go there. But that's what they do, they will go and pay any money for any player. You go and have a look at the number of players that Chelsea and Man City bought in the early days, they paid a fortune for, like Roque Santa Cruz. They went and bought absolutely anybody, and then you start building and building and building, and you could see that
I'm talking about when Abramovich took over, when the Sheikhs took over. Did anybody, you know, predict that there was going to be someone come along and go, you know what, I'm going to play fantasy football with a real team?
Yeah, I think I think people did think that was going to happen. Yeah. And then
at the end of the day, Arsene Wenger set up what he set up, not taking those factors into consideration. And what I mean is by, you know, I'm playing devil's advocate by saying, who would have sat there and gone, well,
they weren't the first team to do it. The first team to do it were Blackburn when they won the league in 91.
But it's different.
Yeah, it is different though, because those teams went to shit. This is something that I mean, like, but if you take Man City and Chelsea out and have them as mid-table teams, which was what they were before that, That's right. You're competing with Manchester United and Liverpool, and how have we done against those teams over the last, 10 years?
Mm.
Other than Manchester United, we've actually done pretty well. And my argument is basically, if it wasn't for Chelsea and Man City, which were things that you could never predict or you wouldn't bother trying to plan around anyway, it would be idiotic to do that. We would have probably won another 2, maybe 3 titles over that time.
Yeah, fair point. I mean, that's why they always look back at it and go, if we knew Man City and Chelsea were going to do what they did, we wouldn't probably have built a new stadium.
Mm. No, that's right.
Money so that
you
cost.
Just take that into account a little bit and sort of.
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
It's a big thing, and I know that people might see it as a cop out or something, but it's got to be something that you take into consideration when you're making judgment calls or when you're forming an opinion. Is to sit there and you really take everything into account, and that's like I said, when Jace asked me, that's what I've tried to do, and you go, well, no one's got any God-given right to win any trophy. We still had to play our socks off to get past Hull last year to win the FA Cup. And I take just as much pleasure in that as if we were to beat Man City in the FA Cup. I couldn't give a shit who it was against, but we got a trophy. And it's hard to win trophies, it's not easy. And then you go and add Manchester City and Chelsea into that. And if it wasn't for the Manchester Cities and Chelsea's, we probably would still have our Nasri's or, even your Fabregas's to an extent, or your Van Persie's and players like that may not have left because they were all leaving for the same reason, which was saying, oh, I'm going for success.
Mm.
My bank account needs some success. But, it changed the landscape of not only, like I said, player wages, but players were getting their heads turned by other clubs because they were basically guaranteed to double their wages and have a pretty good shot at winning something. So if it wasn't, you look at some of the players that we could still have on the books potentially if it wasn't for that, it's a pretty dangerous team. He's not lost his ability to buy and develop players. I think there was a period there where he had no choice. But, when players are forcing through a move and saying, I can get 180K a week at Manchester City, and Sami Nasri sitting there going, I want to leave. And what do? You're not going to keep an unhappy player. If they're going to offer you £24-25 million for the player, you've got to take it. The only criticism I've got is that we didn't reinvest the money properly. That was the thing that frustrated me. However, like I said, you've got to take that into consideration. You've got to think about where we would be over the last 10 years had it not been for those circumstances that aren't controllable by us. And in the long term, how are they going to be when Abramovich and the Sheikhs get bored and don't want to do it anymore, or something goes, or they end up finding themselves financially stuffed somewhere, their little fantasy football team's the first thing that's going to be the thing that goes. So and then they're going to be left with running costs 10 times higher than the amount of revenue they bring in because they were relying on financial injection from the sugar daddies to run. So it is annoying. I know that it's really frustrating to hear, long-term patience, all that kind of stuff, but it's more, I don't think that we can't compete right now, and we proved that today, that we can compete. So there are definitely things that I think that we can improve on internally to make sure we have the best chance possible to compete. But at the same time, when you're talking about criticism over a long period of time, you have to take into consideration more things than just our own backyard. You do have to look over the neighbours and have a bit of a look at what they're doing.
Hmm. Yeah, I think that's a fair point. And David, I think it's David George. I think it's David George said made a good point. Why are we even talking about Wenger? We just played and we beat the champions. It's a good day. It's a very good day. Crack open a stubby.
Oh, absolutely.
And he's right. I think we do almost try and find a negative in a sea of positives sometimes, don't we? Not us.
Well, that's the exact reason that I am like I am when it comes to the manager. I try to take that out of the picture because it has no... There's no point, No. You watch the game, you're happy or you're not happy, and that's how I try to make sure that I stay. I don't really care who the next manager is, and I don't care how long Arsene Wenger stays for, to be honest. I really couldn't give a shit. But I just, like I said, flicked the game on this morning, stayed up all night to watch it, and it was nice to not have to go to work tired after just getting thumped. So,
And the club
will be a very good day today.
The club will be around for many, many years after Arsene is dead and gone.
Oh, absolutely. So,
and people will still be moaning for 10, 20,
yeah,
30,
yeah, 40 absolutely.
Years. Unless we get hit by an asteroid.
Hey?
Unless we get hit by an asteroid.
Well, yeah, there is that. There is that.
Right, I think we should start wrapping this up now. It's been 3 and a bit hours, and I've lost the will to live. And we've reached our peak number of viewers of 85. So So this has been. If people want to go and list, this will be back on YouTube to watch right from the beginning. In about half an hour, I think it takes for this sort to automatically do it. And then we link to this. We have a new section on the podcast site, which shows what did I call it? ABW Radio. There's a new tab on there. You just click on there, and it links all the radio shows to. Then we don't host them; it just links you to straight to YouTube. I called it hashtag ABW Radio Show. You click on there, and we've got some new blogs out from Simon Collins. He's got a new one called Twitter and Transfers. And then just before that, there was another Berkey blog by Jake, which was called.
This is a great.
Assessing Alexis. Mm. That's another really good blog. What are you going to say, Chase?
No, it was. I actually went through it right last night. It was a great blog.
Yeah,
just 100%. I'm not one to really rant and rave on blogs, but Jake Arsenal was spot on with his analysis last night, and well, not last night, but whenever he posted it, and just Alexis is truly one of those players who has surpassed all that we could have thought.
And Jeff's is other Jeff's is on the way. That's the one that I've proofread for him, and that's also really excellent. And that's like a bit of a if anybody doesn't anybody particularly our chaps or ladies in foreign countries where you hear the word transfer window and you go, oh God, I don't really get how all this works. Jeff's written a very extensive piece. I think it's going to come out in 3 parts.
Yeah.
Which not only does it give his views on
like The Hobbit.
Not only does it give his views on the transfer window, but it also gives in clear, concise points how the window works, what certain terms mean, what the definition of a free agent is, all the different things that you'll hear banded about are clearly explained. So anyone that doesn't quite get how these things work, it's a really good read. So I think, because he's in... He's partying it up, isn't he? In
Portland, mighty
at the moment. So yeah. I think he's back late tomorrow, and I think he plans to get part one of the blog out in the coming week. So other words, before deadline day. So look out for that.
And then all the blogs we do, none of them are that bullshit hits and clicks fuckers, because we have not a single advert on our entire site, and I don't think we ever will have. We get offered a few quid every now and then to do it. We've got a little thing for news now, but we don't get paid for that. That's just so they put our stuff up there. If I could figure out how to work it, I'm sure it would go up there. So then we've this week we've hopefully got Anders Limpar on, and he's going to be doing a 45-minute little bit that we'll add on to the podcast maybe at the end. And if we've got to move around some people to accommodate him, so hopefully that will all get done. And then the next radio show, any idea when that's going to be, Kris?
Brighton next Sunday. So we've got the FA Cup
that's
game.
That's 4 o'clock.
It's 4 o'clock. Yeah, so it'll probably be roughly the same time next week.
About 6-ish.
Guests to be announced. It'll either be me or Danny hosting, and then
hopefully it won't be me because I get bored of doing this.
I
think we need a little bit of Raj on here.
On whether Jace is on the pod as well, I'll probably get our Welsh superstar on next week as well. So
you never know, might even get a bit of Kate and Gimli on.
Who knows?
That'd be nice.
Here's some her dulcet female tones telling him to shut up. she's been a little bit poorly. She's had a bit of a sore throat and still had to go to work, standing there all day, being bored, dealing with Welshies.
Toothache as well.
I've been assured that Gimli has been helping her out with painkillers, though, so...
He's a concoction.
Yeah, it's a drawer, and it's just like packets.
Homemade painkillers. He's sorted her right out.
Have you got any announcements to make, Dom, before we go?
Not really, other than the fact that we should all just remember that we've just gone away to the champions and knocked them off 2-0. Someone could shit in my cornflakes in the morning, and I'd still be happy for the day, I think.
Jace, any wise words from you?
Fuck no, I'm almost hammered, so no wise words.
He's just thinking about it, getting his hands on a kebab right about now.
Thank you. My wife is making chili downstairs, and I can smell it, and I am hungry as shit because I did not eat breakfast.
It's about
2:15 in the afternoon here.
He's going to go downstairs and go, wife, where's my food? Fuck's sake.
Exactly. You're going to say the stuff.
The only wise words I have are liquor before beer in the clear, beer before liquor, never been sicker.
I'll write that down in case I ever decide to start drinking. And Kris, I would say, do you want to tell people about all the stuff you've done this week and you've got coming up, but that'll take an hour because you've become a media whore.
No, I've not. It just
How many cons have you done this week?
I've done two.
This is number three, and you've got number four coming up later tonight.
Self-absorbed. It's not three. ABW counts as one. So.
No, it doesn't. No, you've done ABW. Then you did the new one with the American people, which
June
was called...
Is on the mic.
June is on the mic. Yes. And then you did the football show here. You've done the post one, and then you're doing another one later, so that's five. The most I ever did in a week was three.
I just can't stop talking, Danny. You know this.
Oh, there you go. You are... You are now part of the Twitter.
Hey, if people are kind enough to ask me to go on, then who am I to tell them?
And if people ask me, don't. Because me and Gimli used to do all of this back in the day. We used to go on anything and everything because we loved it. And now I say, no, I can't do it because I'm watching telly.
Yeah, yeah.
Because you're too important.
He's sorting out. He's too busy sorting out his colours in his wardrobe.
Right.
Everybody doesn't know. Danny has Asperger's and has massive OCD. If you can tweet him some pictures of things that will annoy him, like maybe some tiles with one that's an odd colour. Things like that. I tweeted him a packet of biscuits that were all around the right way, except one was around the wrong way.
Plug socket.
It really winds him up. So, if you've got any power sockets in your house and you don't have anything in them, turn it on and send him a picture of that. That winds him up as well.
No odd number.
Or maybe the volume of your TV on an odd number.
Yes. Although that annoys me as well, so I'm with him on that one. Labels round the wrong way, that annoys me as well. So,
right. Before we go, I just want to say thank you and hello to Ben Morris and Sumat Singh, Timothy Hargreaves, Antoine, Lee Morris, Carl Walker, Kadeem Reeves, and who else has been there? Kate Antoine, I said that, and then Shastafuk, that's not even a proper word, David George, KMH Hassan.
Some
Old
kind
of
Jason Davies.
Oh, fucking hell, I'm going nowhere, am I? Why isn't everyone called Gary or Trevor anymore? Simi Savile, now then. Joe Madge. What other ones? Jacko Blue.
There's some horrible cratin called Jason Davies lurking somewhere as well.
He'll find you and kill you for that. Nadine Kozler, our lovely Frenchman, Stan the Man. And I don't even know how far back to go. So thank you very much for everyone who's listened today and joined in. It's been a bit of a giggle, and we will be back next week. But we've got the podcast coming out Thursday. Keep an eye out for all the new blogs coming out. The other Jason has been, oh, what a lovely goal.
Oh, yes, Messi hat-trick.
This is shit.
And could you all just finally, Danny, this was an experiment today. So
yes.
Did you just call him Fanny?
Danny Fanny. Fanny Danny.
Jason's gone.
If you if you liked what we did today with regards to the live, it was a little bit
raggedy.
It was a bit all over the shop, but it was a bit of fun. If you did like or if you didn't like it, if you can just tweet the pod account and give us some feedback, what you did like or what you didn't like.
Call us all cunts and we don't really mind.
Yeah, we may do it again, we may not, but if it's popular enough, then we'll probably do it again. We like to do things people enjoy, so if you don't enjoy it, we won't do it.
And remember, if we hadn't have done this, we wouldn't have beat Man City away.
Exactly. It's all down to us. All right. Down to us.
Don't jinx it, fuckers.
Right then. Thank you very much, Dom, Jason and Kris.
No worries.
Thank you.
And thank you very much, everyone listening. This has been an ABW live radio show. Nenu, nenu, you cheeky monkeys. Let it snow. Let it snow.